What's up, guys? Thanks for tuning in to the Tell Me More podcast. On this week's episode, we have comedian from Toronto, Paul Thompson. Paul is currently down in Newfoundland right now. He's staying here for a bit. We're really lucky to have him. And he's just crashing here and doing some things, working on some stuff. And I got lucky enough to get to have him on this episode. Going to have him on a bunch more while he's kicking around here in Newfoundland. And so we just got to sit down and just got right into it and talked about a bunch of silly stuff. Nothing in particular. I'm actually going to do another one where I ask him more about him and his background and his life and whatever. This is just a fun episode of just a bunch of random nonsense. Just really just shooting shit off the top of our heads. And it was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun with it. But you can check him out on Paul Thompson Comedy on his Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, all that jazz. Be sure to follow him. He's been on the Nubian Show. He's got a great recording on that. A bunch of viral videos, toured around Ryan Long, being his opener for a bunch, along with a bunch of other credits. Canada Roast Battle. Just hilarious overall guy, better human. And this is a fun one. I look forward to getting this one out, hearing your feedback, and getting it back on there. I got some more guests lined up to get recorded before I take off for some gigs. If there's any guests that you think you'd like to have, shoot me a message. Let me know. But in the meantime, enjoy this one with Paul. And here it is. Yeah, but don't you got to say, hey, Google, to start the thing?
Well, you just did. Yeah. Now you just said it wrong. You had to say, hey, Google, to set a thing.
She's like, now setting a thing. Okay, starting the thing.
No, don't start the thing. You didn't say, hey, Google. No. How do I know not to?
I don't know, man. Life is weird. I've never seen it do that before.
It's weird. I had one that would do that a lot sometimes. Not a lot, but like infrequently enough that it was creepy. Like once a month, it would just be like, looking up. And you'd be like, what?
I don't get it.
Yeah. I unplug it a lot. Because I feel like...
They listen in on you.
That's why.
But it's terrifying.
So would your phone.
Which is terrifying.
Which is terrifying. But there's something about that one that's a little bit... Yeah. But yeah, Tamara had one. I would always just unplug it. Yeah.
Yeah. Like it's really weird. Mm-hmm. But there's... like you can look up the shit that like they're listening to and like how it affects your life. And that's like
you specifically?
No, the devices. Like
yeah, they do though. They do listen.
It's weird though.
And that it's thrown into your algorithm too.
And like it's all connected to AI. So it's like AI is constantly listening to you. And it's like it just throws shit into your life.
It's just so crazy to think with the AI stuff. Like I'm so terrified about it.
I'm already sick of it.
But,
and I haven't used it.
Of course, but it's ruining us first.
Oh, dude!
Right? Did I send you the George Carlin thing?
What I don't understand is that
I didn't send you that.
I don't think so. I had to have. What did he talked about this?
No, they like took all of his specials, which is like this takes like 2 minutes, and they ran it through an AI thing. And they said that, like, they have an AI generator that's getting better because they were, like, one thing that, like, it can't replace is, like stand-up will be one where it's, like, this, that. And they made an AI. They got George Carlin to do a bit who's dead. They got George Carlin to do a, like, it's, like, a three-minute bit about AI. And it's just, like, it sounds exactly like him and it's written exactly like how he would. And it's, like, actually, like, kind of, like, Carlin-esque, like, funny. That's what's scary. It's, like, so it's over. There's no sense being creative anymore. Do you know what I mean?
That's terrifying, man.
It's horrifying.
Well, here's what I don't understand. Like, everybody, like, if you talk to, like, if you talk to anybody, you'll get, like, one psycho fuck that loves it. 99% plus people already don't like it.
Well, it'd be more like like someone who's, like, lazy, right? Like, I've heard a few comics that, you know, like, and they're, like, they're never good, but, like, they've just been, like, yeah, it's actually awesome, like how much work it does for me. Like, it helps me write this pitch, and, like, I did this and that, and you're, like, don't you understand, like, But it's like, that's who you know. It's like, you're cheap. But you're it's not like, actually creative. If you were a creative person, you'd be, you would know that that's the enemy.
Right. Like, but it's really, you know? Like, people are talking about the internet and cell phones have, like, made us dumb, right? Mm-hmm. But, like, this is on steroids. This is sure. A whole other level of that.
But here's what's crazy.
It's really like, dumbing our brains, man.
Sure, but the reason why it scares me is, like, you can see all of the stuff that it's doing creativity-wise. I mean, like, also, like, visual art-wise, like, that's severely in the last year discouraged me from like painting and visual arts like so much, and that's like my heart and soul. Like I love studying arts, I love art history. The entire pandemic I spent painting 16 hours a day, and I've just slowed down now because for me to do a portrait that takes me literally 60 hours, knowing that like you can just type into AI, can you turn this into something? And I know that there's something about that hard solid project, like product that's actually like painted, but like no one's hitting me up to do their album covers, and people used to ask me all the time and stuff like that. Like, you don't need, because, like, what's the thing? Like, if I was to originally paint, like, a cool painted album cover, the fact that you can just type that in and be like, can you paint an album cover for me, 70s style, this, that, and the AI will just do it. It's, like, it's going to destroy graphic artists. It's already doing that.
It's destroying so much. It's going to destroy me. What if it's, like, it's listening to all of us, right? So
oh, and it's planning,
which it is, and it's planning its attack against us. So like, 100. So like, it keeps hearing us talk about how awesome it is and how it's so like we keep giving it approval.
Well, maybe people do,
like, but like we're saying, like we are talking right now. Our phones are listening to us right now as we talk about how good it is,
yeah.
And how it's done. But it's and it, like, do you know what I'm saying?
But here's the thing that we maybe need to be scared of. Is you're saying people talking about how awesome it is, those are the people that don't need to be scared. But us, we're talking about how much it sucks, how much it's
no, but they
people,
do. No,
but maybe no. We're the kids in the class that bully the crazy kid.
Yeah, but no,
that's going to bring a gun to
school.
No, but
we still
when AI snaps, it was like, say it again.
No, but what
say
if,
it again.
But what if AI is, because right now AI knows it still needs mankind, is what I'm saying, right?
Yeah.
But if it keeps picking up, like, okay, we just did the Carlin thing, and then it hears like millions of people say, oh, dude, that was amazing. They go, okay, we were able to do that. And it's like, this thing's amazing, that thing's amazing, that thing's amazing. And it knows, okay, we are getting human approval. We're getting good at all of these things. And then, like, there was some sort of, I seen something a few months ago. It was saying how, like, somebody, like, went down a rabbit hole of asking, I think it was ChatGPT, like, a bunch of questions.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And eventually, it explained, like, how it's going to take over the world. Like, the AI explained to the person, like, yeah, like pretty well, like AI is going to take over the world, and here's how we're going to do it. And it's just like, how is that? Okay, how is that not all we need to hear to say, Buzz, let's ban this worldwide?
I mean, but it's too late now. But it's like, I'd say we would, but it's like, it's too late now. Here's the other thing that's scary
about
it.
But how is it too late?
Because who's going to do that? Like, the thing is like, sure, you could ban. You know what makes
It's too late. It's realistically too late.
Well, it's
because it's not too late in theory.
The thing that makes the ban more scary. Okay, I'd be happy if you just banned it from consumers, because that still just kind of saves some artists' jobs and stuff like that, and some writers' jobs.
Ban it from everything, man.
But to ban it from everything, there's a million people that just have access from this, and they will. Once something's on the internet, it's always there. Do you know what I mean? So there's a million
people. Yeah, but like, you should get like the death
smart.
Penalty if you're caught with it. Like make it extremely.
That's true. We should come to an agreement that like we make this illegal.
Like, how many movies and shit have we need to see to understand like? This is a horrible idea. Like,
because there's certain stuff that like you could benefit from AI. So, but it's like, so things should have to be rammed past like a system and be like, can you approve it that AI will help this system work better and blah, blah, blah. And you're like, cool, then we can use AI. But for stuff like art and intellectual property and things that are creative and things that it's just stealing jobs and it's making kids like it can write essays for them. It's like, let's take that away.
I've heard like the pros and the cons, right? And like I heard some scientists or some geek fellow, whatever he was going on saying about how the discovery of AI is like fire, is the discovery of fire, right? And how like it just slingshot mankind to this whole other phase of society, and how fire could be used as completely revolutionizing society and making
weapons
and being used for so much good, right? Could be fire is used for so much for heat and energy and everything else. Like it's combustion and stuff is used for so much. But fire can also be used for so much bad, right?
The other thing that's scary about it, too, is, like, use, like, video games, for example. But you can use any technology. Use cell phones, use this. But let's think about video games. Think about the difference in the last, how long has it been, too? Like, let's say 25 years, really. Like, when original Nintendo, or at least, let's say, even 25 years ago, was Super Nintendo came out. Maybe. Around then. 30 years, maybe. No. Around, like, 25 years ago, it was, like, Sega and Super Nintendo, yeah? So, just think about the difference between that and the PS5. Do you know what I mean? Think about the difference between the first iPhone and this iPhone. Yeah. Think about the difference between flip phones and the iPhone. That's in the past 15 years. So, like, what does AI look like in the next 10 years? That's terrifying. Terrifying.
I know.
There's so many things going on right now, and it's so discouraging to me. That's like, how are we not at the end of days? Do you know what I'm saying?
It feels like it, though, don't it?
Yeah. Beyond feeling like it, it looks like it. You don't have to be... It's beyond a conspiracy now. You don't have to, like... There's things with the weather and stuff like this, like, that is a little bit scary. The world is, like, people are turning evil. People are turning on each other. There's, like... I mean, like we said, like, the news. You know what I mean? There's horrible stuff happening in the news. The Mayor Gander's upset. That's not good. If that doesn't mean anything to you, that's not going to wake you up.
Oh, my God. That was the best. Jodie Cook, right? Michael Connors just has some story that it goes to Jodie Cook, and she just goes, well, the mayor of Gander is upset.
Word for word, that's what you said.
Well, the mayor
of Gander's upset today.
Yeah. Well, the mayor of Gander is upset today. Yeah. So-and-so has more. It's like, well, like the well. And there's something about upset. Well and upset.
Upset is so, it's so, it's just so like non-news time. Well, the Mayor of Gander is upset today.
Well, the Mayor of Gander is upset today. Roll the tape.
And you know what? When they cut to him, he was pretty upset. He was rather cross.
He was so...
Like, he wasn't just doing an interview. You could see he was a little bit shooken up. He was upset.
Yeah, I bet you... Sometime this week, he called VOC Mountain Lion. Do you know about VOC Mountain Lion? Have you ever listened to VOC Mountain Lion?
Oh, you've told me about that. Oh, my God. Yeah, yeah,
it's the radio equivalent of NTV News. Yeah. Like, it's just perfect.
Yeah, you've told me
it's
about that. That's
perfect.
So, have you called into it?
Oh, yeah. I've called into VOC Mountain Lion.
And gotten through?
The first time I called VOC Mountain Lion, I was in grade 8.
So you're doing pranks and stuff?
No, like? No. I was very serious. I was very upset.
What were you upset with?
Actually, the very first time I called, I was upset about the Conn Smythe winner. You gotta understand. This is a TV show. This is a radio show. One of the most popular radio talk shows in Canada, like viewership wise. Like back in the day too, like before the internet, dude. Open line.
Yeah.
Half the province was listening every night, man. That's like open line, massive.
And
massive.
The Conn Smythe happens right after the Stanley Cup.
Yeah.
So you were watching that live, and you got rotted right then and there.
But not only was I watching it live, I was in grade 8.
Yeah.
And it was in Dallas. So the game was up late, right? It was a West Coast game.
So it's like 1 a.m. in the morning. Finishing. Well, like, especially when they're doing the cup.
Yeah.
I believe
it was Dallas versus New Jersey. And I feel like that's who it was. Anyways,
that sounds right.
I thought the Conn Smythe, my take that I called it on. But see, the host used to be George McLaren was his name.
Right.
And George McLaren.
Is that when the Devils won it, right? And Scotty Gomez was the rookie.
I honestly think
that does sound about right. That's like 1998, 1999.
I can't remember because Dallas won the cup too, right around that time. They both won somewhere in like a five. I believe it was like a 5-year window where both teams won.
Right.
So I can't remember which one won. To be honest with you, I think the Devils won.
The Devils, I do remember winning because they had Scott Gomez as the rookie.
Yeah.
From Alaska,
And then
Alaska. Alaska Gomez is from Mexico.
I think he's from Alaska.
Gomez.
Yeah.
He's brown, and his last
he's
name
not
is
brown.
Scott Gomez had a tint.
He had hair like me, you know.
Ez Gomez.
Yeah, Gomez. The Adams family. Their last name's Gomez.
Adams.
Oh yeah.
What are you talking?
That is the dumbest thing I have said in months. The literal title of the show is their last name. Oh my
the Adams
god, that
last
was
name
stupid.
Is Gomez.
The dad's name's Gomez, though. That's why I said that. Gomez Adams.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, that was dumb. Wow. Adams.
You idiot.
That was so dumb.
Oh, that's perfect. Yeah, you know, Gomez, because it was a big deal, man, because there was like a, like he was American born, but his parents were Mexican.
His parents are, yeah, Dalia Gomez and Carlos Gomez.
Right.
He's born in Anchorage, Alaska.
And that's where the Alaska's coming from.
That's where the Alaska's
what?
Coming from? What do you mean?
What? What I was mean? Wondering what the fuck you said Alaska.
Yeah, I said he was born in, he's from Alaska. He was from Alaska.
Yeah, but I was saying Mexico. But I knew he was right. American, but like I didn't know he was from Alaska.
But yeah, he probably does. Oh, you're right, though. He does look kind of Spanish, though. I'm sure his parents are Spanish.
Yeah, he's brown, right?
Well, he's Mexican.
Mexican brown.
Maybe.
Mexicans, a lot of Mexicans are brown, right? Like light brown.
Skin color, but I don't know if that's how you would refer to it.
Yeah, but
you would just say they're Latino.
Well, I don't call a yellow person purple. I call or a black person red. Right, I go by the skin color. If his skin color is brown, I'm going to call him brown.
Yeah,
Mexican brown.
Sometimes it's like, I feel like
yeah,
Indians,
but there's Mexican, yeah, but there's Mexican brown Indian. And Indian brown. Two different browns.
Yeah. Yeah. But then the thing is like there's certain like Guyanese people who look black, but you'd still call them brown. And their skin's like pretty
where's
close
Guyanese?
To black. Where's Guyana?
Or where's Guyana? Guyana, is that Africa?
South America.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Where's Guyanese? Jeez. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I guess he would be. Yeah, he's kind of brown. He's brownish. He'd be a light brown.
Mm-hmm.
He's Latino, I'm sure. Born December 23rd. You got a feel for him.
December 23rd. Who was?
Scott Gomez.
That's incredible.
Awfully
do
close
you,
to Christmas.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what's amazing to that is that he was born in December, made it NHL. Do you know there's a stat on like most professional athletes, like the percentage of athletes that are born in like January or February is crazy because
you're either the oldest.
Because right, so what happened? Like if you're of your class, of your draft class,
yeah,
and even as a child,
yeah,
right. So like, when you're in like under sevens,
yeah,
right,
yeah.
You're like the old, like the difference between you at seven and someone who's born in December at seven,
oh,
right, and especially at that age too, like every fucking month matters, right?
It does,
in childhood.
Yeah, you can grow a lot in a year.
Yeah, you can grow a lot in a few months.
You can grow it a lot in a summer.
Yes,
yeah,
in a summer, right? Exactly. So so like usually the best kids, like the children that didn't get to go up to like upper leagues and then start going like to like. Like in hockey, for example, like going to like AAA hockey, and then they do good, and then the kids that do good in AAA hockey, and then go to junior hockey and all that stuff, right? It's always the best ones, and the best ones are usually born early in the year because they got.
I was gonna say, think January would put you at an advantage if you're really good at hockey. You're always the youngest, so you're always playing against people who are older.
I wonder where he was born so late in December. Growing up. They put him, because sometimes that will happen. Sometimes, like, well, at home, I didn't remember, there was a few times, like, kids that are born really late in the year, they would be put in sports. And even in grade school, they'd actually hold them back. They'd wait a year before they put them in the thing. So they're always, technically too old to be in a thing, but only about like a week or so, right?
Yeah.
A couple weeks.
Yeah, yeah.
So but it was more conducive, like it was more fair because you're so far behind, right? Especially in school.
Yeah, like if you're like in grade 7, but one of your buddies is born in January and the other one's born in December, those they're almost a year apart.
Right.
That's interesting.
Mm-hmm. So like that's I remember because I remember there was a kid and I can't remember their name. But I remember there was a kid that was older. Or was that would that be the other way around? I'm not even sure. But there was a kid that one thing, like technically should have been in a different grade, but they weren't, and it was a parent's choice to do that.
Interesting.
Yeah.
That's that chai right there. That's that chai. Yeah, that's interesting. Do you know what I remember so distinctly? And this is so dumb looking back on it. I think it was kind of only in grade 3.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think it stopped. Now, I don't remember doing this in grade 4, but I have distinct memories in grade 3 that I was like, and I have no reason to believe this, that I thought I was smarter than my whole class. Zero reason to believe that. Also, I'm sure if we pulled up the grades, I wasn't. I never had high grades in school. Nothing. Maybe I was well-spoken. Like, I didn't get nervous to speak in front of the class. I was good at reading. I don't know. For some odd reason, I thought I was just smarter than most of the class. And anytime somebody would come into my classroom, I remember this specifically in grade 3, I'd be like, here we go. Like, if someone came in the classroom that I didn't recognize, and they were like, can I borrow you for a second? And, like, would bring the teacher out, I'd be like, I literally would start packing my things. I'm like, here, I'm skipping a grade. I remember that so distinctly in grade 3 that throughout the year that I thought someone was going to come and then they were going to be like, Paul, can we speak with you? And I was going to go in the hallway and be like, yeah, I expected this. They're like, so you're smarter than most of the students here.
You're going up a grade.
And we're putting you up a grade.
Yeah. Meanwhile, the conversation I'm in the hallway is like, I'm so hungover and I did not do the lesson plan. What am I supposed to be saying to these kids? What am I supposed to be saying?
Crazy.
And it's like, just tell them to look over the periodic table of elements and to study that because there's a pop quiz coming up.
In grade 3.
Whatever grade.
Yeah. Just tell them look at the periodic table.
I can't remember what grade
these
that was.
These kids are like, what is this? This big thing. I have to memorize it. All these letters. I just learned what K is. Now that's potassium. Like, I just learned the sound it makes.
Like, you can literally tell me that we started learning that chart in grade 3, and I'd be like, yeah. Because I can't remember if it was grade 3 or grade 9 or grade 5.
I think it's grade 9. It's grade 9, actually. I'm 100% sure it's grade 9.
It's all a blur to me, man.
Yeah.
It's all a blur. All I remember is was in social studies, we kept learning about the Beathics and Inuit and stuff. Every fucking year, man, we learned about that. You don't know what I'm talking about, do you?
No.
No, that's a Newfoundland. That's a Newfoundland thing.
Yeah.
Because we had to learn about all the different indigenous groups. And I remember like social studies in grade 5.
Yeah, we didn't learn
and
that.
Social studies in grade 9 was almost always the same, man. You used to learn the same shit every fucking year, man. Like every year might be a little bit different, but then you'd get to the indigenous part and it was the same thing every year.
I remember the most I learned on that topic was I went to grade 1 and 2 in Texas, right? So I remember every year around November, around Thanksgiving, doing full units, full studies. This just hit me the other day and I was like, whoa, like spending our whole 2 weeks and I'm like drawing pictures, I'm doing presentations and learning the story of Thanksgiving. And when I was thinking about what the story of Thanksgiving was that I learned for 2 years, I'm like, I don't know when you stop learning this or if they, but when I went to school, okay, so this is 25 years ago, when I was in grade 1 and 2, we would spend a long time learning the story. And the story that we would learn is like America was not the best place. It was overrun by savages. They would use that word, savages. They didn't really know what to do. Like they, you know, they could hunt and they could do this, but it was just, you know, there wasn't a lot going on. Then European, Christopher Columbus, great guy, hero. He came over and was like, you guys can do better than this. You know, you're sleeping in teepees. You know what I mean? You barely know. So he showed them like how to hunt. You know what I mean? How to make food, how to do this. That's where the turkey comes from. You know, you kill the turkey. He did this whole thing. He taught them everything. He just, you know, he came over and they were friends and he made America a better place. That's how America started. And they were like, thank you, you know? And then other settlers came and like America is what we know today, the greatest country in the world. Thanks to him, Christopher Columbus, the hero who came and like made it a better. Like, I don't know if they do that anymore, but like, especially now, I'm like, if they still do that, you're probably in grade one and two. Like, I mean, times are different. You tell that to your parents, like that's not true at all. At all. Like, but I remember when I was young, like we would just learn the story of Thanksgiving and it was like, yeah, Christopher Columbus was a hero. They were never saying this guy came over and stole land and raped and pillaged.
Right, because that's what happened.
Yeah, that's what happened.
I was saying, Paul, what are you talking about?
Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, no, I'm not saying that I believe that.
I thought you were telling me that's what happened, giving me a history lesson, and I was like, fuck,
yeah, I was wondering.
Was I wrong?
You were kind of like, hold on, what? No. God, no.
He came over and took over.
Yeah, that's why I said it was wrong right
off
the bat.
And he's seen UFOs along the way.
You think so? Well, that's why I also, dude, just let me clarify. That's
true.
Why I was saying it was bad.
He has journal entries talking about seeing UFOs.
Really?
Yes. Look that up.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then he went crazy and said, wherever I get, I'm taking over. I just made that up. But.
Wow.
He did two things. Those two things did happen.
That's wild. Yeah. But no, and they would say, like, I remember in class that they would say, like, they were a bit, like, they were, like, kind of savages and stuff.
Did he land in Columbus? Why is Columbus called Columbus?
It's his last name.
Yeah, but...
Just like Adams is someone's last
name. Yeah, but, like,
you know?
Did he land in... Where did he dock? Is there water in Columbus? He didn't... He's not John Cabot.
No, he docked...
We're not
meant
Christopher...
He docked in America.
Christopher Columbus.
Wait, Christopher Columbus came from
America, Europe. Yeah, but what state?
He's from Europe.
Where did he dock? When he hit America's soil, what state
well,
did he...
not Columbus. Columbus, one, isn't a state. It's in Ohio. And Ohio's not along water. So, I see where you were going with that. But there's there's no way...
I didn't say he did. I was asking a question.
Yeah, there's no
I was way. Like, well, why is Columbus called Columbus?
Because what happened was Christopher Columbus came across. He saw the shores, beautiful, Maine.
The shores of Columbus.
What we now know is New York. And he was like, this is pretty cool. He saw everything. It was good. And then he traveled down
to the
south.
Did he dock in Boston? Bahamas. This is America.
It's America.
It's
Central America.
That's where he came to first?
Yes. What?
Bahamas?
So what is that? So how did he... What?
What?
I thought he landed in USA.
I thought he was definitely. My guess would have been.
Oh my God, man.
My guess
mind
would have been
getting
right.
Fucking blown.
Yeah, I would have guessed he would have been like. He would have.
And in school, they told you he landed in America and taught the indigenous how to cook turkeys.
Correct. Yeah.
So
he never even went to America.
So he hit a bunch of Caribbean islands, and then he kidnapped indigenous and brought him back to Europe, and then he came back across the Atlantic again, and then he hit America. Where'd he go on the next trip if he didn't go to America? Trinidad, the northern coast of South America.
The east coast of Central America.
The east coast of Central America. And what? And then he took off back to the UK again.
Well, he wasn't from the UK. I think he's from Spain.
Spain.
That's what you're saying, yeah.
What?
Those were three separate trips.
Three separate trips. Okay. So what did he do? What did he do? A half a dozen trips before he bumped into the east coast of the States. When did he get to the States?
I don't know why. I that's a thing that they talk about. That Christopher Columbus is the main name I remember coming up around Thanksgiving.
Yeah, he's our John Cabot.
Yeah, we were just learning about. I also too. That name sounds familiar, but I don't
John
know.
Cabot.
So John Cabot came over.
John Cabot discovered Newfoundland in 1497.
Oh,
But he was on his way. Wasn't John Cabot on the way to somewhere else, and he bumped into Newfoundland by mistake?
Where's he from?
Europe somewhere, over that way somewhere. John Cabot.
And he stayed in Newfoundland.
Well, he ended up going back to Europe, wherever he was from, and told whatever leaders over there that we got to take over this place because of the codfish.
Oh, he liked the cod there.
But, like, there was a Canadian Heritage moment on it. You know them commercials that used to run? The Canadian Heritage moments? So he had one where it was they sail over and they're looking down and it's just like codfish are on top of the water, like a goldfish on top of a tank, like wanting the food, right? They're just cod everywhere. And you could just take buckets with a rope and put it down over the boat and just put the bucket in. And just haul a bucket up, and the bucket be full of cod.
Around Newfoundland.
All around Newfoundland. And the thing was, he went back to the ruler of wherever the hell he was from, or some high up guy.
And he was like, there's bear fish out here.
And he said, there's enough codfish to do mankind until the end of time. And he swore on his life that there's enough cod there to serve everyone until the end of time.
Yeah, which...
And because it was insane amount of cod.
Yeah.
So then that was why.
Why do you think we have less now? Fishing or maybe
the draggers,
environment?
The draggers.
They're dragging the nets.
The big draggers. The big Jesus draggers. And not the long liners. The draggers.
And
you
those
know,
guys are
a dragger like the size of a fucking small cruise ship, right? Just dragging these massive old, like, and you had God knows how many hundreds or thousands of them throughout the coast.
Right.
Just day after day after day, just overfishing, man.
Mm-hmm.
And then eventually,
and
the cod
so
stocks are gone. And in 1992, the cod moratorium happened?
Yeah.
1992, the cod moratorium happened, where they ended big time cod fishery. And then there's a recreation cod fishery that happens every year where you get 10 tags and you can catch 10 cod.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
But that's all. But back in the day, like, there was like, you could catch a shit ton of cod. And everybody could go do it and sell it. And it's like the most delicious fish there is, man. Cod is wicked.
Cod's amazing.
Right?
Yeah.
So,
Arctic char, but.
Arctic char.
That's a good fish, too.
Yeah, Arctic char is incredible. My favorite fish.
Is
Arctic char.
Have you ever had tilapia?
Never heard of tilapia. It sounds like somewhere down the Caribbean, though, isn't it?
Never heard of tilapia?
No, sounds like your last name of a UFC fighter. Tilapia.
What? You've never had tilapia? Tilapia is fire.
Tilapia.
That's definitely like a Jamaican dish.
Sounds like a Spanish stripper.
Oh, tilapia is
tilapia.
So good. Rip the eye out.
Right on your
right
lap.
There.
Tilapia.
Tilapia is really good. Really
What's it taste good. Like? Tilapia.
Well, a lot of times it's like jerked and stuff. So it's like the seasoning that they use. But
yeah,
I guess it tastes like, I mean, like they all kind of, it's, I don't know. I don't even know how to describe, like, you know, you want to know an interesting thing with fish, you know, catfishing, obviously, you
catfish.
Know, like on Tinder and stuff, you got catfish.
Yeah.
Right. Like you know what that means?
Yeah.
So where that comes from, I think it's cod as well, but that term actually has like some history behind it. Right. So catfishing is like, yeah, you like match with someone. Oh, she's really hot. And then you meet up in person.
She's not
like,
hot.
She's not. She's not even the same person.
Right.
Right? So catfishing is from like, I think they were sending like, let's say it was cod, but I might not be right about the fish, but like I think maybe it was cod. So like the fishermen are taking cod. They're packing them up into like these like boxes where there's water. So like
the boats are gone. The fish are gone.
So they can swim around, right?
Yeah.
They put them in the box and and you love that bit too much.
I love that bit. Anyways, keep going.
So let's say, anyways, when they were sending it to wherever they were sending it to, the cod would just like lie there and wouldn't do anything.
Yeah.
And it would show up and they'd be dead and they'd be mushy.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You can't be laughing about someone else's bit during. How are you laughing about someone? I'm trying to get through this here. How are you laughing about?
The reason I'm laughing is so fucking laughing. I'm laughing. And now I'm laughing while you're trying to
I'm trying to explain history, and out of nowhere, you just interrupt with someone's bit, and then now you're just laughing about it. I'm trying to tell you it's a cool fact. It would have taken 10 seconds if you didn't do some fucking other person's bit.
No. Anyways, back to tilapia.
This isn't tilapia.
No, what are we talking about?
The catfishing thing.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. So when they're sending the cod, wherever they were sending it to, the cod would just stay in the box and it would be dead. So it'd be mushy because the fish isn't fresh. It's mushy, right? So like, okay, this is brutal. But then they realized that if you take a catfish has more like excitement to them. So if they put one catfish in the box, the catfish would swim around and they would just keep kicking because the catfish is annoying them. And because they keep swimming, they'd stay alive. Do you see what I'm saying?
Mm.
But then when the box arrived, people were like, sick, I ordered 8 cod. And they're like, that's not a cod. The look, there'd be a catfish in there. Like, I got catfished.
Where did you hear this?
If you had been listening. I don't know. I just heard it somewhere. But yeah, the catfish would stimulate the cod. That would have been a great clip if you had to let me get right through it. We could have cut that in. It would have gone viral. It would have been like, this is a great historic clip.
No, listen to me.
And then instead you're like, the fish are gone.
The boat's gone. The fish are gone.
Interrupting a bit from 1991.
2002.
Oh, God. 2002.
Tommy Tiernan's his first ever special. Phenomenal. Dude, I'm sorry. Sorry.
What made you even think that?
I don't know.
I said the fish.
What?
I said the fish. We were talking about fish for a while before, though. Yeah.
Oh, man. Anything could have
triggered that.
I don't know. Ah, it don't take much to trigger me, though. Like, my ADD head, yeah, right? Yeah. Like, I'll just go on. I don't know. I think a part of it was I think I was just trying to be random and make you laugh. And in turn, I just made myself laugh.
Yeah, I was trying to be serious for once.
I know.
I was like, listen to this. This is a history fact. I even set it up. I think that's what it was. Sometimes when you're too serious, it's too much tension. And then it's like being at a funeral and you're like, I feel like making a joke right now.
Oh, dude, he also has a bit about laughing at a funeral.
Oh, it's the best.
It's so... It's
you have to.
It's so funny. He talks about how a classmate, how he was in grade, he was like in junior high-ish, mm-hmm. whatever it is, 7th, 8th, 9th grade. And one of the students in their class, their father died. Mm-hmm. So the whole class got the day off school to go attend their classmate's father's funeral, to be there with their classmate. Interesting. Right?
That doesn't happen in real life.
Yeah, I wouldn't know if that type of thing would... That would definitely happen in Newfoundland in some towns for fucking sure. Oh, yeah,
maybe in some towns.
You're yeah, right. Like small towns. Like, not big cities,
no.
But probably not. Like, I don't know, I didn't
yeah, you're right. In a small town, that would happen right. For sure, yeah.
So, definitely. Like, and he talks about how... Yeah, and how he got all these kids out at a funeral for the first time all together, mm-hmm. right? And how he's like, and the tension and the grief was fucking huge. Mm-hmm. And he's like, and we were only 14. He's like, and it didn't. And he said, and you knew it just wouldn't take much to set us off, and it did not. And he goes right into like what happened and how like one kid just started giggling, yeah. And then when one kid started giggling, the other one started, and then the other, and it was just contagious. And next thing you know, how the whole fucking pew was just going, and then they're laughing, and they're trying to pretend that they're crying, but they're laughing.
Yeah.
And then the harder they would laugh, the more they would try to sell it off like they were crying, but they're now it looks like the whole row was like screeching, but they're actually dying laughing. And he does this whole bit, and it's fucking, it's classic. It's the best laughing at a funeral bit I've ever heard. It's so good. Yeah.
Sounds great. Thank clip that up. Get that on there. Imagine that. Imagine you saw a clip on Instagram of somebody explaining someone's bit. There is a bit.
There is.
So good. Where this guy, he talks about his wife, but he hates his wife.
Yeah.
And you're like, what am I watching right now? This is this joke has gone through three filters now. Just share the bit. I never understand that. Pull a bit up then.
Yeah.
Jamie, pull up the clip.
Yeah, no, see, but this production isn't there yet.
Yeah, you don't have a Jamie.
Yeah. Like it, you know what I mean? TV? You know what I mean? Like, cameras are good, mics are good, lighting is good. Don't have that guy yet.
No. You'll get that guy.
Maybe someday.
Maybe.
I'm going to have a TV there. Right? Maybe. On the wall.
Espresso. Sometimes he comes over, he makes an espresso. That's not good. That's terrible for the production, but he needs his coffee.
Comes in right behind, starts making it in the middle of the podcast.
Come on, man. It's in the middle of when I'm trying to say another history fact.
Oh, man.
I can't get anything out here. It's either you singing or this guy making his coffee. What am I doing?
Oh, dude, once I get laughing, like, proper laughing.
Oh, yeah, it's,
like, it's just my, like, it's so heady.
I sometimes,
and, like, I have a hard time coming back down, where, like, everything's funny. Everything is funny.
No, I hear you. There is sometimes, though, too, like, on that tip, and, like, this has happened to me, like, it happened to me a few weeks ago, but, like, most times I'm good for this, but every now and then, like, someone tells me something really serious, and especially if it's like a good friend and it's gonna take a while and I hate it, but then sometimes something will happen in my head and I'm just like, don't laugh. And I'm like, why would I laugh? Like, you know what I mean? Like, they're telling me about like bad, like, health.
Dude, Bobby Lee is the best at that.
You know, like health things that they're going through with like their family and stuff like that, and then this, and it's like super serious, and like I'm concerned and I care and it's my friend, but there's something in the back of my head that's like, don't laugh. And it's not even like laugh. I don't think I'm going to burst out laughing, but I'm like, don't smirk. Like, there's something in my face that's going to be like, just for a split second.
Did you ever see the clip where Bobby Lee is on with Brian Callen and Brendan Schaub? And he talks about when he was 12 years old, he used to get molested every day.
Yeah.
And he'd be like, I got to tell you something. Don't laugh.
Yeah.
Keep telling them not to laugh.
Yeah.
Every day for a week, I was brutally molested. Yeah.
It's so good. That's so good.
And the boss would laugh. And he'd be like,
said they would.
And he'd, he'd be like, fuck you guys.
And don't laugh. Say don't laugh. He knows what he's doing.
But every time he'd say don't laugh, and he would restart the story, he'd always add more words and like more details.
He knew what he was doing.
Oh, he knew.
Genius.
He's genius, boy. He's one of the best, man.
Yeah, he's so
His stand up, I haven't seen a whole lot of it, but what I have seen is so funny, man.
Really? I don't think I've seen it ever.
Oh, man. I can't wait for him to put out a special, man. Him and Theo Von are just like.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, well, I mean, when they get going, I mean, they've done ones together, right? Yes, they've had those.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. A bunch. A bunch together.
Yeah.
I've
seen clips.
Yeah, the clips are out there.
Yeah.
There's clips.
Just clips.
Yeah.
Fuck, dude. Sorry, I just got derailed there.
But yeah. Just got derailed. Get a good thing going.
But that's the other thing, too, right? Like, you know what I don't like doing? I don't like, I hate, like the whole, to me, and I've said this in other episodes before, but the whole point of a podcast is just like, you know, try to pretend that, like, you know, none of this exists. The cameras, 100%. The mics, all that stuff. Mm-hmm. And just, it's just about capturing.
So yeah, like you so, want to.
So I hate. Yeah, I hate it when it's too formal. Like sometimes if it's like when I did the one with Tyler and we're talking about Jehovah's Witness and how he got into cult.
Yeah,
like that was like serious, like me, like properly, like interviewing him and asking questions and giving him a spot, like to tee him up for him to go.
Yeah, there's a difference between an interview and a podcast,
right? You know? And I just like just catching us being idiots.
Oh, for sure,
shooting shit. Because how many times have we had conversations? Wherever, couch, car, wherever, and just be like, "Fuck, man! Like, if all this was being caught right now, this would be great.
We'd be in jail. We'd be in jail. Yeah, think about that every single day. Fuck, that's what I think about more. I'm not like, man, I wish we had that on tape.
See, I think
once a day, maybe I'm like, oh, that would have been a good thing to have on tape. Five times a day, I'm like, thank God that wasn't on tape.
I keep thinking more and more, like, yeah, it's fucking thrown up there like a hockey. No, but like, I think all the time, like, this would be great because, like, I feel like people just want to feel like they're just sat in on the conversation.
For sure.
So I try not to overthink. I try just to be loose and silly and whenever I can, especially like silly fucks like yourself.
Do you think that, like, so many people have like cameras in their house now and stuff like that? Right? Like, they just have cameras in their house?
Yeah, we got one over there on TV.
Yeah, yeah. Like, I wonder, like, how much that's going to, like, more and more, like, just help solve, like, murders and stuff.
You know? I mean, it can't go down. It's got to go up. Right?
Like,
it's got to increase solving. It's not going to decrease.
Yeah, yeah, increase. Yeah, the cases are going to be, like, more. There's going to be less unsolved.
Yeah.
Because they're going to help with the camera.
It has to.
Also, too, what's really good for the camera, though, is there's some amazing funny moments.
Mm.
Have you not done that
yet,
though?
Oh, the doorbell ones are the best.
The doorbell ones are awesome.
Yeah, because
some of them are fake, you can tell, but whatever. Mm. The game is the game, right? AI. But, what? It's true.
The doorbell game is the doorbell game, man.
The game, baby.
The game is the game, baby.
But have you never had, like, because you've had that there for like 2 months now, that camera.
Mm-hmm.
Has it never ran across your mind when you're saying what you just said? You're like, man, sometimes you're like, I wish that was on tape. Like, kind of is. Has there never been something that just the funniest thing happened and you're like, let's pull that up? Because you could technically do that.
What thing. Camera?
You had the camera right there that we just talked about.
In the living room?
Correct.
Right.
So if something really funny happened and you were sitting there at the couch, technically speaking, you're like, I should grab that clip.
Right, but I don't...
Which probably isn't the best way to
think. I don't
think
it's... But I don't... That camera's... No, that camera only records...
Video?
I think when the alarm is enabled. Right? So an alarm is disabled most times because we're home and even when we're gone, like the doors are locked. Like, obviously, if we're going somewhere late, but if we're just popping in for a couple hours in the middle of the day, we're not alarming the system because the cat will keep setting it off.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
Right?
Wait, so, but when you're gone and you set the alarm, then it starts recording.
Yeah. Only, yeah.
Oh, so only if someone comes in while the alarm's set.
Right, then that starts recording.
Then it starts recording. Oh.
Right.
So there's a lot of pressure on the burglars to be funny then, if you're going to get a clip. I hope they come in. The fish are gone.
The burglar just comes in, gets in the living room. The boat's are gone. Yeah. But, no, I used to say all the time when me, Tyler, and Nick were living together, like, I wish our house was set up like Big Brother, just like cameras in every corner of every room.
Sure.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, if we had, like, little GoPros up in the corners of every room and the rooms were mic'd, every day, man, every day,
yeah,
there would have been something caught to go that would have...
But I wonder if that changes it sometimes, because it's, like, literally, like, the scientific, like, we know that molecules respond differently when they're being observed. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, like, whether you know it or not, you know that you are. But isn't that crazy, like, that they've done that? You've seen that.
I've seen that.
So, it's like, yeah, like, I mean, you would get used to it that the camera's always on, and I don't doubt that there would still be funny stuff, but it's just, like, it might have just taken away the magic. It
most
certainly would.
I guess what I meant was, like, I wish it was there and we didn't know it was there. Like, well, I wish it existed.
I hear you.
Yeah.
Which is then...
I'm speaking hypothetically, like...
Which is then... That's one of my favorite things to think, like, amongst a million other things. But it's like, if heaven could be anything, that's a major thing I would want in heaven. I would love that. To be able to pull up any clip from the past. That'd be an amazing thing in heaven.
Any memory.
But you know what I also would like? If you could pull up... Because there'd be certain memories. You'd be like, let me watch this. Let me watch that. That'd be awesome. But I would also like to, like, have like highlight reels cut together.
To show all your heaven buddies.
No. For example, here's the first one that came to mind. But you can tell me one that you would want to see once I'll give you my example, okay? Example number one, show me the top five, rated in order, starting from number five. Show me the top five times I was closest to dying before I actually died. Let me see those. Do you know what I mean?
Near misses that you didn't know were near misses?
I might know a couple of them more. There might be like me like, whoa, jumping out of the way from a car and be like, oh, yeah, I remember that. Damn, that was close. But then there might also be like something I didn't even notice happening. Show me the top five. Like that's first example. Also, like show me the top five hardest I made people laugh. Whether it's, and then maybe I could be like, give me an onstage version. Give me an offstage version. Do you know what I mean? Show me the top five hardest I laughed in my life. Do you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. How sick would that be? The highlights all day.
The top five steamiest moments of your parents banging.
Yeah. Show me the top five times that I cried. Oh, the footage isn't there? That's right. I never cried. Why would I cry if I've never been loved? Treating God still with angst? It's literally God. And why wasn't I loved? That was the path you chose for me? Hmm? Everything happens for a reason? Well, here it is. I'm in heaven. What was the reason? For me to be pissed off? For me to not ever think I was good enough? Thanks, God. I'm going back to my cloud. Just treating God like shit. Fuck you.
Bring me a bagel.
You're not my real dad. You're not the real father. That's so, angsty to God is so good.
You're my God. You're my real father. You're my godfather, not my real father.
Yeah. Or son. Or Holy Spirit. But you can't slam doors in heaven.
Because there's no doors. It's just clouds and blue.
You're just trying to make a cloud? Get out of here. I hate you.
But sounds can still come through clouds.
Yeah, it's just clouds and blue. That's so funny. That can't be. We pass through the clouds. Maybe it's just space.
Top five.
But there's so many top fives that would be sick to see.
Yeah.
Wait.
I tell you what I would look up. I would look up like history stuff like before I was even around. Like,
oh, of course.
Like I'd want like.
That'd be amazing.
I would like show me the reality to like five conspiracies. So like I'd want to know like. I'd want to know like say like 9/11 like what really happened and then show show me it. You know, like what really happened behind closed doors? Was that planned or not?
Oh, absolutely. You or know? Even just asking questions.
And then show me the clips of like fellas sat down and being like, this is what we're going to do. And be like, no, yeah, that's not how it happened.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, and then we're going to do it. Right. And or the phone calls or however.
I'm truly asking. Think about this before you answer. Would you want to see? Maybe not the whole thing, but at least the moment like when your dad busted.
I knew that was coming. Yeah, I knew it, but would you though?
But would you? Think about it. Would you?
Yeah.
Because it is. You would?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
I don't know. Like at the end of the day, it'd be interesting. I kind of want to know what like the room looks
tell you
like.
What, no, I'd like to see. I tell you what, not that. But what I'd like to see is everything before that. So I'd like to see.
That led up to the sex.
Like all that night. And, like, the cab ride there, the stumbling through. And, like, the end of it would just be, like, the bedroom door closing or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't need to know what goes on in there.
No, I know. Yeah, me neither.
Right?
But, yeah, I hear you. I'd like to see the lead up to it before the rated R stuff starts.
I was already told enough that it's in my head and I don't need to see it.
No. Yeah. That would be cool, though.
Yeah.
Just to see. I kind of want to see the room, though, and stuff.
The decor.
Yeah.
Yeah, was there pictures on the wall?
There might have been pictures. It was in Alberta. That's all I know. All I know is it was in Alberta.
Mom was in Ontario.
Yours was in Ontario?
Yeah.
Really? Yeah. Were you born in Ontario?
Yeah.
What?
Brampton, baby.
Really?
Don't mess with the B.
And then you moved right away?
18 months.
Wow.
18 months old.
How do you feel about that? Because you're such a Newfoundland guy, but you're not born in Newfoundland.
I know.
Does that sting?
It, you know, for a long time, do you know that I hid that?
It's like, I'm a Newfoundlander, born and bred.
Right. Because I remember telling people when I was like junior high, just a couple of friends, like, saying, like, it was nutting, like, you know?
Yeah.
And I was getting bullied about it.
I bet you would.
Because it was like, you're not a real Newfoundlander, you know? And I was being told I wasn't a real Newfoundlander.
Yeah.
And I was like, what the fuck ever? I'm like, I don't remember that. I have no memory of Ontario.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, my memory begins in Newfoundland.
Yeah.
Like, I was a baby when my parents moved
18
back.
18 months, yeah.
So I was like, I don't, and then to be like, you're Trentonian, you're just that. I'm like, and then, you know, when you're like 12 years old, you're like, no, I'm not.
Yeah.
Like, right? And then I was like, you know what? Fuck that. And even like early, like, and I held on to that, like, early on, like, I remember in my comedy, like, first, like, so many years into comedy, I was like, I remember wanting to kind of mention on stage that I wasn't born in Newfoundland. And I was like,
you said it on stage yourself?
No, I would never.
Someone said it.
No, no one said it. There was moments that I would maybe want to mention it, just say it, something in passing,
you're
right?
That you'd want to, yeah.
And I was like, no, like, I was like, nobody can ever know.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, to your point, like, I've had, like, some people being like, oh, he's such a newfie and this and that, right? And I'm like, yeah, like, because, you know, especially too, like, when, like, you're always a little bit insecure as a comic no matter what. But, like, in the beginning, I mean, especially in the beginning, it just as a young person and as a young human and as a young comic, like, you're really trying to find your identity and your voice and your perspective, like, and how you're trying to tap into how am I perceived, right?
Yeah.
And then you get a taste of how you're perceived, and you go, that's how I'm perceived, and they like it. Okay, well, now I got to stay in that box, right? Because that's how I'm perceived, and that's what they like.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of comics get trapped into that, like, oh, I can't talk about this and that with my fan base because my fan base will boo that because my fan base likes this or that and blah 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 blah, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you get pigeonholed by your own fans,
right?
But like, it's a self-made prison, and it's like, so I was like, well, no one can ever know, right? And then I don't know. Just as the years went by, like, just as I get older, I just start. You know, what am I even doing? Like, who gives a fuck?
I mean,
if there was anybody, like, especially at this age, if there was any grown adults that was like, fuck him, because I'm born there, I'd be like, that's not someone you want as a fan, anyways.
No, yeah, I mean, I've gone through that always, and it does bother me because I'm like, I don't know where my home would be, right? Because I was born in Alberta.
Right.
But then we moved after 2 months because I was just done with it. I wanted to, like, do my own thing.
Right.
Right? And then at 2 months. Yeah. And then, that's the part where you start taking it serious, eh? Right. Gotcha. No. I moved after 2 months, and then I went to Winnipeg for a bit. And then I was in Texas. But I've moved all over.
Yeah.
But the longest place I've ever lived, I lived in Toronto for 16 years. Right? And that's like...
Why'd you do
that? That's half my life.
Because your parents.
No, I moved to Toronto because I wanted to pursue comedy. I moved on my own. Right? But I moved a bunch with my parents. I lived, like, you know, in Texas and Winnipeg and Alberta and Ottawa. Right?
Why would your parents be around all the time again?
Military.
You're a military kid. I knew that.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting that.
Yeah. So for me, it's like the brutal thing is, like, when people are like, where are you from? I'm like, I'm from Toronto. I would say I'm from Toronto. It's where I've spent half of my life, you know? But then everyone in Toronto is like, you're not from Toronto? It's like, you didn't grow up in Toronto. So then where am I from?
Because
if I'm in Alberta and I tell people I'm actually from Alberta,
that's
like, where?
That's a big problem that military kids have, though, is that identity of, like.
Yeah, so where am I from? I have no idea. I don't have a sense of home.
Canada.
At all.
You're from Canada.
Yeah.
You lived a little bit in America, but you're Canadian. You're from
Canada.
I'm
definitely Canadian.
Yeah.
Which,
so,
you know, I was proud of
that's,
up until
that's
like
got
a
to
year
be
ago.
What your scope is. Like, it's got to just be bigger. You're not from a certain part of the country. You're from the whole country.
Yeah, I'm from Canada. I mean, yeah, definitely. I mean, when I was like in England for a bit, I definitely just said, that's where I'm from. I'm from Canada.
Right.
You know?
And that's what you have to tell the world. Yeah, I'm Canadian. I'm from Canada.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, think about someone who's from England.
Definitely Canadian.
Think about someone who's from England.
Mm-hmm.
Like, imagine having an identity crisis saying they didn't know where they were from. And you'd be like,
wow,
like,
England. Like, if you're from Liverpool, it's a big difference between being from Liverpool than from London.
No. I get that. But, like, I'm talking about someone's perspective. Like, anyone that's not from England or from Europe. Yeah. Like, if I heard of a person and they say, I don't know where I'm from, and I'd be like, well, where have you lived your whole life? And mm-hmm. And they tell me all places that are inside of England, like they've never mm-hmm. lived outside of England, I'd be like, what the fuck's your identity crisis? You're from England.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like you know what I mean? So I think...
I mean, I would still just say, like, if I had to pick where I'm from, like, I would still say Toronto for the time being.
Yeah, well, you've lived your whole adult life there, right?
I've lived my whole adult life there. Yeah. It's like, that's who I am.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah. But at the same time, too, like... Well, at the same time, too, now that's how I actually don't really say that a lot. Like, it depends. If it's a quick question, like, if it's a comedy-wise, like, oh, I've never seen you before. Where are you from? I'm from Toronto. Like, comedy-wise, I'm from Toronto. But, like, if someone's really asking, like, so where are you from? Like, if I'm in, like, in a podcast and someone's like, where are you from? Then I'm always like, a lot of places.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? Sit down. What happened was the cod, they were shipping them over, but the cod would get sleepy and it would die. So the cod would turn mushy. So they took a catfish. Put a catfish in the box. The catfish would kick around. Kept the cod alive. That's where the term comes from. Catfishing. See what I'm saying?
So you were a cod.
They were kept alive from a catfish. The point is, I was the catfish. Every place was boring. And I came shaking up.
You got re-catnated.
You were re-catnated. Stupid. That's... Yeah, so I don't know. I don't know what to. I keep thinking this the past, but I went to the museum with my niece and nephew, and I was super tired. I only slept like 2 hours before, but like, I can keep the energy because I love my niece and nephew. Mm. So anything they're like saying, like even sometimes I'd be like, man, I'm so tired. And I was just out of it. And I was just in a super sad mood. I've been in a dark place. You know what I mean? But no matter what, that's what I realized. That's what true love is like if my niece or nephew were like, look at this, and I'm not faking it, I genuinely would be like, that's awesome. Cause I'm so happy to see them happy.
Mm.
And they were away and I was just like zoned out, just standing by a tank. And some kid, random kid who was like six, just looked at this like tank of fish. He's like, look, there's a catfish. And I was like, cool. And I thought about that for 2 days that I was like, one, I couldn't fake it for the kid. But for the next 2 days, I felt so shitty. I was like, what a dick. Because I could see that the kid was like, oh, maybe like, that's probably the last time he'll talk to a stranger. Like, I just remember I just didn't give him the enthusiasm I would have given my niece and nephew. He was like, look, there's a catfish. And I was like, and I even looked too. I like looked and I was like, nice. And you could just see that he was so disappointed by my real response. And I was like, well.
Just that's look the, at him.
That's literally what I did. He was like six.
I'm like, life gets horrible. True love doesn't exist.
Yeah, I was like, oh yeah, catfish. Glad you brought that
full,
one up.
Full Billy Madison. Stay here. Stay here as long as you can.
Life's gonna catfish you. God's a catfish. His parents are like, all right, let's go see the caves. Can I come? No, we're going to keep that guy out of the cave, I think, for a long time. I think his life's a cave right now. And he can't see the light. How do you know that, Dad? I was once there, too.
Oh, man.
God. The sadness is like yours, Dad. Only around your mother-in-law.
How cold do you think that water is? Not as cold as the barrel that I put in my mouth every time I think of your mother-in-law. Or the mother-in-law.
Imagine killing yourself and the note just says, this is your mom's fault. That's the most like brutal.
The father-in-law shouldn't have gotten upset over everything.
Like it's the funniest thing in the world to me. People hating their mother-in-law.
Oh, it's crazy, man.
Like I've never been able to relate to that. Like I don't understand.
I haven't either. I've been very lucky.
But even then, I've still dated girls who like their moms were like. Not like I didn't like they were like weird. Like I dated a girl, her mom was like their whole family like didn't like her and stuff and like this that, but like I didn't like I was like whatever. I still like going to dinner with her and like this and like I could see that she was definitely like strange, but I was like whatever. I got along with her and stuff. Like I don't know what it would take for me to be like, my mother-in-law. Do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, you would just need one that like can't stay out of it. Always, yeah. always gonna have to say. Okay, I tell you when it gets really
and
bad.
And your wife.
They're always having influence, like too much influence, oversetting boundaries.
Yeah,
that's what causes it.
Yes.
Right. Like,
and
like,
your wife would have to entertain.
Let's just
it,
say,
though,
like
too.
You and your wife are really excited about something, really want to do something,
mm-hmm.
or whatever it may be. Could be mm-hmm. ending it all.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden,
catfish story, maybe. I usually get excited to tell that one, but then not when it gets interrupted and ruins the whole momentum. Johan? I see what you're saying. You're going on a trip or something, and then she's like, "This, I don't think you guys should stay where you're staying."
Yeah, or I don't think you should go or whatever, and all of a sudden your missus comes and like, yeah, like, I don't want to do that thing now. I'd be like, why? Because mom said this and that and blah,
but
blah,
that's
blah.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd be mad at my mother-in-law. That's just a wife I can't be with. Because if the scenario was like my wife was on my page and the mother-in-law was like, you shouldn't stay in Italy this time of year, this, that. And then she's like, my mom's saying we shouldn't stay there. As long as we had an understanding that I'd be like, well,
yeah, but
your
like,
mom
even,
says that a lot.
Okay, but
she's like,
think
I know.
About it. Think about it. Yeah. Yes, you're
but
right.
If your wife was like, no, my mom did make a good, like, that's it.
But like some sort of brutal guilt tripping over could be a guilt trip over something or for doing for going to Italy or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, and it's constant and it never ends.
Yeah.
And it's like can never and or just is constantly pessimistic or constantly that always bring anytime you're excited about it, just is always just knocking you down.
Yeah.
Right. Like it just be like, yeah, I can totally see why people mm-hmm. would hate their in-laws if they were always like that.
Yeah, I guess. Okay, I got a question for you.
Okay.
You know how guys, I think this is like a guys versus girls question, right? The guys we a lot like throughout our life will be like with like our buddies and stuff. Like I think maybe he's gay and stuff. Like that's happened a few times. And then like even like last night we were talking about like certain like athletes and stuff, right? Do you think girls do that? Girls are ever like, maybe she's a lesbian. Not as much as we do, right? I don't see girl like groups of friends being like, maybe she's a lesbian.
I don't know.
Think they do?
Maybe.
As much as us, or do you think we do it more? Because I feel like guys, like, we speculate a lot that we're like, maybe he's gay.
Right.
Like, 3 times a year, one of my friends will think that one of my friends is gay. And I don't think that's just, like, my life. Like, you know what I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
Like, all the time, people are like,
yeah, you know,
he hasn't talked to a girl in, like, a year. Yeah, maybe he's gay. And then we all get together and we all, like,
start speculating.
I don't know when that stops, too. Because I was going to say, remember when we were in high school? But it's like, no, that still happens well into
our
30s.
It's funny. You know what? It's funny is I was kind of thinking something along that line there a while back because I was just like, there was a while where I had a friend group that was just like, yeah, I was just like, it's always coming up, like speculating on someone else. And I'd be like, and I'm like, Buzz, like, is you got nothing else to talk about? Like, and I just remember like, and I'm like, why does this group always do that? And then I realize it's because they don't like sports. So they got
nothing. And if they don't like sports,
they got
then
nothing
maybe
else to talk about.
Look what happens. Look, we're right back at square one. Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, I guess if you don't like sports. Yeah, you're right. There's a weird abyss that, like, if you don't like sports and you're not a nerd, what do you talk about?
What do you talk about?
Yeah.
Right?
That's
so you're just
true.
Yeah. Like,
it's true.
Or like, I mean, I guess you can talk about any hobby, it could be traveling or whatever, but like,
yeah, you would talk about your travels a lot.
Yeah.
You can get pretty into family.
Right.
But I think a lot of narcissists would fall into that category.
Yeah.
Because they don't mind talking about themselves.
Yeah.
I mean,
I don't know. It's weird. Like, what? Yeah. What do they talk about?
Well, we don't talk about sports.
No.
At all. But we talk about life a lot. And then we also talk about our friends a lot.
I think a lot of times I hear girls talk about when they're talking about other girls, they're usually talking about other girls that they hate and why they hate them, or they talk about girls that they're jealous of and why they're jealous of
and why they hate them.
And why they
do
hate
they
them.
Admit to being jealous? Not many people admit to being
sometimes.
Jealous. Tell me somebody who you're jealous of. It doesn't need to be, don't get that personal. Tell me like a celebrity or something. It doesn't need to be like a person, like person that you know, because that's.
I mean, Conor Rogan, I guess. Like when you think about it, like why wouldn't you be? Like he's got his own comedy club.
Yeah.
Right. Gets the gets like front row seats to the best fights in the world.
I think that's just cool. I'm not jealous. I'd be like inspired.
Yeah. Well,
I don't feel. There's
okay,
people
but
I
okay,
feel,
but I'm not really jealous. I don't feel jealous of anyone. Like
I do.
But see, like I don't know. I'm not.
I probably two. Then other than most celebrities are like they did that. There's probably a lot I could get into, but I'll tell you two people who I'm like jealous to the point where like I don't like them. You know what I mean? It's Little Dicky, Jack Harlow. I don't know if the word's jealous. I'm definitely jealous, but I'm also bitter because I like rap music. I used to rap a lot when I was young. They look the same as me. They're not doing anything different that I couldn't do. And I'm just so like fucking Jack Harlow especially. And now all the time people are like, man, you're like comedy Jack Harlow. I'm like, bro, Jack Harlow started 3 years ago. I've done look like this. And just we look the same. Yeah, I'm really jealous. And then now Little Dicky too. Little Dicky like slipped into comedy and has a funny show. And people are like, you would love the show. I'm like, no, I wouldn't. Fuck him. And then I actually did just watch the show with Luke like a couple months ago. And I was like, yeah, it is good too. And that sucked. You know? I hate that. I hate when you hate somebody. And then like I'm still like have enough artistic integrity that like something they do is good. I hate that.
I think the only time I get jealous is when if I get really dark, I'll just get jealous of the dead.
Of the dead?
Of the dead.
Wow, that's...
Because I'm like, I wish I was there right now.
Yeah. Forever, though? Maybe a little visit.
Oh, dude, you get
I mean, I hear you, but then it's like... I don't think I'm jealous of the dead. Jealous of the attention
but I don't
get,
feel,
maybe, but...
I don't,
you know.
Yeah, like, I don't really feel jealousy a lot. Like, overall, man, if I'm completely
and
honest...
And it's a sin. You shouldn't.
And I don't, like, it's... Like... Yeah, I don't...
But I think sometimes, too, it's a hard one for us to pinpoint, too.
Yeah.
Right?
Like, I have been a lot. Like
I think we...
Growing up, I used to get jealous of everyone all the time.
I think
I got jealous of so many people so much all throughout my life that I almost got jealous out, and I kind of just, like, got over it and just started...
That's good,
Like, remember what we were talking about the other night about just, like I just don't pay attention to this
or
that or whatever?
Yeah, we were talking about
that last night. Yeah, last night, like... I that's true. Like I don't, and
but
I'll
you were
just,
you were talking about somebody who you were jealous of, but now.
Yeah. Whatever. Like,
the guy with the glaze over the eyes.
Yeah. Like years ago. And like, there'd be a little bit of being like, fuck. Yeah. And there'd,
but
and there'd
to
be some
admit,
jealousy.
Jealousy though, I think is also a mature thing. And that's where it starts. Cause I think there's a lot of people that are like brutally jealous and it just comes off as like, like, you might even ask that person, like, are you jealous? And they'll be like, am I jealous? No. And they'll be like, I'm pissed off. I'm annoyed.
Yeah.
I think it's bullshit. But it's like, I think it's a really mature thing.
Yeah, like, that's where I get.
Where sometimes, too, sometimes really I'm really mad and I'm this and I have to catch myself. I mean, it's happened to me today. You know what I mean? I'm just in my head. I'm going through this thing. And all of a sudden, I start to feel this feeling in my gut where I'm, like, sad and I'm angry and I feel defeated. And I'm like, one, you're doing comparisons right now. And, yeah, you're just jealous. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You're jealous. That's
it.
And then it's just like, and once you pinpoint that it's jealousy, it's like jealousy is never a good thing. So you are wrong. Do you know what I mean? Like anytime I catch myself being like, you're jealous, I'm like, oh, there it is. I need to say it out loud in my head. You're jealous. And it's like, and you're wrong.
Mm-hmm.
There's never any time that it's healthy to be jealous. You're wrong.
Mm-hmm.
So what are you going to do from here? But you need to drop this feeling as soon as possible and move on because this is doing nothing but good to you. These are bad feelings.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes anger could turn into something good. Sometimes, you know, these things can be like sources of drive. But I think jealousy, like, no, it's not good. Jealousy and competition are different things. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, and jealousy is just bad. Like, you can see in comedy and in the arts, too. Like, when people are fueled by jealousy.
I might get jealous. Like, I'll get jealous. Maybe if somebody is on like, and it's not even real jealous. It's like a light form of it, I guess. Like I say it, but I don't fully mean it. But I do mean it a bit. Like say if like, sorry, like someone is at like a concert that I really wish I could be at. I'd be like jealous.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what I mean? That's good. Like, that's healthy.
Like, I'd be like,
oh, I get that all the time.
I'd be like, fuck, I'm jealous. Like, gee, what I wouldn't give to be there right now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I'll get it like in like those forms, but actually like long term, like holding on to it for anything anything longer than like a moment.
Yeah.
Like, I don't really struggle with that.
Yeah, you're just jealous in moments and stuff like that. Like, I definitely get like that. But I just know that it's not something. But there's nobody that, like, I would hold on to that I'll forever be jealous of. I mean, never say never. Who knows what's going to happen, right? But.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, overall, like, I don't know. Like, I guess in my life, I've worked so hard. Like, all the good things I have in my life, I've worked so hard, or I've made so many hard sacrifices and been through so many hard moments to get the things that I have that I'm really happy with.
Yeah.
And then the things that I want that I don't have, I just use that as a way to, like, be hard on myself and to motivate myself, and I use that almost as a reason to live, as a driving force.
For sure.
So, yeah. Yeah, I don't know when exactly I stopped and started thinking all this stuff.
You
tone
it down. You should at least, but like, yeah.
But like,
when you're a kid, you feel it a lot.
Yeah. Oh, fuck, man. As a kid, I was jealous of everyone as a kid.
I remember sometimes they would, like, we'd have assemblies. And there'd be, like, certain people, and it was always, like, the same guy, too. But, like, just, like a guy that, like, went to gymnastics, and then, like, the whole school would be there, and then they'd be like, all right, special treat. And they'd, like, bring this guy up just to do, like, a backflip or something. And that jealousy would eat. I would hate that shit.
Really?
And I was like, yeah, oh, my God, yeah. When I was, like, in grade 5, 600 kids in the gym, and they'd be like, but one last treat. And all the girls, like, ooh, and this kid would come up and do, like, a cartwheel. Or something, everybody would cheer. You know what I mean? But whatever. I could also probably do a cartwheel, and like, if you told me how, in like a week. I guarantee you, if you could see, that would be a clip I would love to see.
Total.
You know what I mean? I'm just everybody going, wow, clapping. You would just see me being like,
yeah, I could totally skip. I could totally skip a grade if I wanted to. Like.
And then I also remember,
you can,
like,
backflip. Well, I can flip over a grade if a teacher would just fucking notice me.
I remember also, like, in like grade 7, anytime somebody would come to the class, I'd always be like, it's because they're gonna bring me back a grade.
Back a grade.
Yeah, that's what I
went the opposite way.
I started thinking that I'm gonna get kicked out of school or something like that.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. I would think like, yeah, because that's when I started getting in trouble and stuff. But I remember too, like, I always did pretty good. We didn't start high school till grade 9, right? So I remember, like, grade 7 and 8 and everything like that. Like, yeah, I would, like, struggle sometimes. Like, I just didn't care for school. You know what I mean? And I don't know. Like, my grades just weren't that good. But I would get by. 70s. Always over 70s. 70s, maybe 80s and stuff. Then I remember I just hated it. I hated school. Then I remember in grade 9, like, I remember it, too. Like, the second day, like, science class, okay, and then finish this homework. And then I remember the next day, I was like, oh, my God. Like, I didn't do my homework. And my stomach's sinking. And I was like, I started trying to, like, do, like, the classic, which I would do all throughout, like, elementary school, like, trying to do it in the desk before the teacher came to check. And then the teacher never came to check. And I was like, okay. And then I remember, like, the next day, like, yeah, do this project. And then, like, they never came to check. And I was like, what? Like, none of my teachers are checking the homework. So I was just like, yeah, I don't have to do anything, you know? And I remember, like, halfway through, you get, like, a halfway through, like, report card. And I remember just being, like, I remember, too, being, like, high school is sick. Or just thinking, too, like, I just cracked the system. Like, I'm, like, I just show up to every class. Like, I wasn't skipping. But I was also, like, you never, like, I never have to do homework. Like, I used to have to always do homework. Now in high school, I'm, like, you don't have to do homework. Like, they don't check. It doesn't matter.
Right.
But I didn't realize that, like, at a certain point, like, you need to do the homework so you can learn what's on the test. And so you learn that.
Oh, right. I need to do it for other reasons.
I remember, like, when I got the report card, I was like, huh. Like, I remember, like, flipping it over. Like, that can't be right. That's got to be. Like, I swear my first report card was, like, 14, like, 21. These are the percentages. You know what I mean? Like 23 and like a 39. And that was gym. That one, there's no excuse for. That's just, I'm just bad at sports because there isn't homework. That's just like, I'm just scared of volleyball. I am. I hate it. It hits me in the face all the time. I really hate it. I hate volleyball. So
how did you get a 39 in gym?
I actually,
you're
don't
joking.
Know. No, I'm all that's true. Like, I'm actually scared of like volleyball.
No, yeah, okay, the volleyball thing, but you didn't fail gym.
I think I kind of actually had a bad grade in gym. It came back up. But I remember, like, even the second time around, like, I was even, like, low in gym. I don't know why. Yeah.
Low in gym?
I think I just wasn't wanting to participate.
Jesus, man, I was a fat fuck, and even I was getting 85s at least in gym.
No, I wasn't doing good in gym. I was not doing good in gym. I would refuse to do certain things and stuff. Like, I don't like
really?
Sports. Yeah, I really don't like volleyball.
I'm so competitive that I would... I remember we had...
I didn't
like it. We had one thing where we had to run... certain distance. It was like 100 laps around the gym or something, but it, and which worked out to be however many kilometers or whatever, right? And I remember we did, and like, you gotta understand, like, man, when I was in high school, dude, like, I was proper, like, proper fat. Right. Like, a proper, like, man, I was at, like, I had a year or two where I got really, actually, like, I was starting to, there was a couple kids that were maybe fatter than me, but I was starting to like compete for being like the fattest kid in the grade,
right?
In the whole grade, not the class or the grade. Like, I was getting pretty big. Now, there was others bigger than me, but I had a little bit where I was getting there, man. And then I was like, fuck, we gotta do this running, right?
Yeah.
And I've never actually ran like that. Like, I've played played a lot of basketball.
Yeah.
And a lot of ball hockey, floor hockey, and softball, and all the stuff. But never actually went running. Right? And I'll never forget it, man. Like I'm getting lapped by like some of the ones that are like quite athletic and great shape and in great shape and stuff. And I remember the school record was like, was slightly under 10 minutes was like the school record in the history of the school or since they started like taking notes of it.
Was this like Terry Fox?
And a buddy of mine and a
was
and
it?
A buddy what?
Was this like for the Terry Fox thing?
No, this was just gym. This was just it was just a thing that we were getting graded on, like came like I guess getting graded on our cardio essentially.
Yeah.
And my buddy Tyler, he was determined to beat the record, and if I'm not mistaken, he ended up beating it by like 8 seconds or something. Like,
that's sick.
Yeah. So he ended up lapping me like a pile of times.
Yeah.
And then like as you're going around, more and more kids all of a sudden like, oh, they just stop because they're done, right? And then you're still going. And I remember there was some kids that stopped. They got to a certain limit and they just tapped out. And I refused.
Good.
And just I refused. And like, I remember by the end of it, I remember there were some kids that went outside and threw up when they were done, which it was funny. I've never understood. I never threw up from running.
But
I've heard a lot of people doing that. They're like, when they run hard, they never know when they throw up. And I just kept going. And then I was like, just like pretty well just like speed walking essentially, but I wouldn't stop.
Yeah.
And I remember when I was done, I collapsed.
Yeah.
And I remember like, it was like, you ever like just spin around a bunch in a circle,
make
yourself dizzy as a kid.
Yeah.
It was like that. And I fell on the floor and the room was just spinning. But I remember like a few of the boys and they're like, a bunch of people were like clapping their hands, were like, fuck yeah, man, good for you. Like, you did it.
Yeah. That's
and I was
wicked.
Like, you fuck. I was like, yeah, I did it. Like, you know, but like, I'm going to do it. But like, it took me like twice as long as like a bunch of people to get
it
done. But
you did it.
But I did it, right?
Yeah. Because
I was always just so competitive.
No, that rules.
Like that.
Yeah.
I just wasn't competitive enough to ever be. My whole life, I've always struggled with consistency in anything.
Yeah, I was never good with that either. You know what's funny though is like, I remember always struggling too with like the cardio and stuff, and like there's a track, and like this is from like grades 4 to 8. There's like a track at my elementary school, and I would run it, and I always just like didn't like it, and I don't know why. I guess like I just wasn't like, I actually did try and stuff, but like I just, my cardio was low, and just like I just wasn't like one of the faster kids,
right?
You know, like I would try, anyways. My sister lives behind my elementary school. She like lives super close and like close to my parents, right? So like this time when I was just like back like visiting my family for like 2 weeks and stuff, like I run now. And now like in the past year especially, like this is the best cardio, the best running shape I've ever been in my life times 10. And where I go for the runs is where that track. And man, it was hitting me. Like I was listening to music and I'd go for the run and then I would just go naturally to the school. But then when I started going on the track, I was like, yeah, what's up? Look at these numbers now, motherfucker. You know what I mean?
Right.
And I was thinking about like people who were mean to me in that grade and stuff like that. I'm like, I bet you don't even run anymore.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? And I was thinking about like, yeah, maybe when I was in grade 8, no. But I was like, but now, even though I'm in my 30s, I'm like, cares. That was legit every day I was running around my old school, and it was like, which I don't know, maybe stupid, but it was motivating me just to be like, you know, I'm still here. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like I wasn't just like, well, I wasn't good at running, and like, you know what I mean? It's just like, I don't know. There was something metaphorical to me that I was just like, yeah, even when I was 25, I wouldn't have been that good at running.
Right.
But now I'm like, and I struggled and I'm bad at running. Like, you know what I mean? Today, like when you said that, when you're getting dizzy, today at the gym, I pushed myself so hard, incline, going on the treadmill, and when I was done, when I got off, I felt dizzy. I felt that. I felt the spin. And my heart was pounding.
Yeah.
Couldn't breathe. But yeah. I was like, good. I pushed myself hard.
I was proper fat fuck in high school.
Mm-hmm.
And then I graduated high school, and it was after that, I remember when I was at Buzz, and Buzz, we were going for a run around a pond, and I was like, sakes. And like I didn't want to be left out.
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah, I'll go for a run.
Mm-hmm.
I was there. There's a pond back in Buren. It's across from like the Royal Garage, which means not new, but like in across from like College North Atlantic.
Mm-hmm.
So, I guess it's called Salt Pond. And there's a walking trail around. It was like 2-point-something kilometers to go. Anyways, we start jogging, but you get up to like there's this bridge and like on the road, and you just walk down onto the path.
Mm-hmm.
We started jogging, and I got, like, here to, like, the intersection,
mm-hmm.
which is nothing.
Right.
Right? Which mm-hmm. is, like, 3 or 4 houses down from here.
Okay.
Right?
Like from that intersection.
Yeah, from this house to, like, that intersection. That's a roundabout.
Yeah, so that's the about intersection. 60 meters.
Yeah. Like
maybe.
No, Jesus, not even that.
50 that's, meters, yeah.
No, to that intersection, like, the one I'm talking about, it's, like, 3 houses, I wouldn't say it's that, man. I'd say it's 30 meters.
Yeah, maybe 30
meters. It's,
yeah,
so.
30, 40, yeah.
Yeah, so, like, it was about that.
Mm-hmm.
And Boz all played hockey and stuff growing up, right?
Yeah.
And I was the one that was out of shape there. Boz are all in shape going for run.
Yeah.
I'm like, I'll join you. And I had to stop. Dude, like, I'm literally, like, I'm talking 15 seconds in, man.
Yeah.
Like, not even.
Yeah.
Like, it's right there.
Yeah.
And I had to stop the biggest fucking stitch.
Yeah.
On my side. And the boys all fucking started busting laughing at me, right? And I was like, fuck off, boys, fuck off. Right? And then I had to stop and walk. And then I start jogging again. And I get, like, 20 seconds. And, fucking stitch. Right?
Yeah.
Get a stitch. Fuck. Mm-hmm. Anyways, it took me over an hour to get around this pond.
But you did it.
Or close to it.
And you had to go by yourself.
But I got, yeah, like, yeah, the bars are all like, when I finally got to the edge of the trail, the bars like, Jesus, we're going to go out without you, man. Like, we're starting to wonder if you're dead back there. And
yeah.
I was like, fuck off, boss. Like, you know? And then, anyways, then I was like, fuck, man. And then I started going, like, sneaking off by myself. So I was so embarrassed. Mm-hmm. I was so sick and tired of being fat and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like, I'm going again, going again. And I started going. And then I started, like, I got addicted to running. And then,
yeah, 100%.
And then I will never forget the day that I got around the whole trail. I did a whole one full lap without stopping.
Right.
No and stitches and stop. And I was like, holy fuck, I
That's
did it.
That's cool, yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. And did it. And then I was like, now I got to do 2 laps.
Mm-hmm.
And then I did 2. And then, you know, and then like only be like, you know, 100 or a couple hundred meters into the second lap first time. And then I got to stop. But then eventually I was doing 2 laps. Then I got to a point where I was doing 3 laps. And then I got, and then I remember the first time I did 3 laps around the pond, it was like about 50 minutes, 48 minutes, something like that, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then by the time, and it was like by the end of the summer, or I can't remember, it was like, it feels like it was like
6 months, but maybe it was a year. Like, it's all a blur. But, like, I was doing it in, like, 28, 29 minutes. Sick. And then I found out Boz on the soccer team, like, to run the Challenge Cup beer and soccer team. Like, I was getting some of the times that some of the soccer players knew, and they weren't doing it in that time. And I was like, no way.
Yeah, that's
like,
the competitiveness
right,
is wicked.
Right, like, there were some soccer players that were doing it. Like, there was one in particular. Apparently, he was doing, like, 18, which was fucking insane. I was like, how the fuck is he doing it in 18? Yeah. Right? But I was beating some, apparently, some players on the team. And, like, whether that's true or not, that's what I was told. I leaned right. It was the last 55 pounds. And I did it all from running. Wicked. Didn't lift many weights. Yeah. It was cardio. And my cardio got, like, and I got phenomenal cardio shape.
Yeah, and that's what you were saying. You said you have good heart cardio and hockey and stuff.
Too. Yeah. Like, yeah. I every time I get fat and out of shape.
You do have good cardio at the gym and stuff.
Yeah, like, every time I get fat and out of shape, too, like, I'll go play hockey and I'll play two shifts and I'm dead, right? Yeah. But if I start playing 2-3 games a week, but at the end of the month, I'm usually, like, not only can I play a game good, but, like, a lot of times, like, I'll stick around and the skate after us is short on players. Like, I'm looking to go for a second game.
Sure, yeah, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I get my cardio back pretty good. Even now, when I got weight on, I get my cardio back.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah, cardio can come back quick.
Yeah.
That was the thing. I never liked the running either until I got, like, an app. Once I got an app that was, like, showing me how fast I'm going, timed my run, showed me the kilometers and stuff, and I could start marking it. Because for me, I was like, I still don't get this. I don't get putting my headphones in and just going for a run.
Right.
But, like,
that's why
exactly what you're saying is, like, putting my headphones in and going for a run, but then I'm like, okay, it took me this amount of time to run 5 kilometers. Now I'm like, no, let's beat that.
Right.
Let's beat that. That I can do all day. But what I will admit is, like, and I've been doing that. I've been running like that. I mean, even when I was talking about, like, in Ottawa when I was running, like, there wasn't snow yet or anything. So I've still, even if it's cold, I'm still running. But this is the first time in, like, 2 years that I've been running on the treadmill the past 2 days. And it's like, yeah, like, I'm doing it and stuff. But, like, man, like, it's very boring.
Yeah.
That's my biggest struggle. It's like I'm not even, like, out of cardio. My legs aren't even sore. But I'm like, this is so
boring. Well, the thing with cardio, like, half of it is that's the thing. Cardio is as much as a mental battle as it is a physical one.
It really is.
It is, because, like, that whole boredom thing.
Like, on the treadmill, big time. I don't get bored if I'm running around town. I'm like, now let's go this way. Now let's go that way. Yeah. That doesn't get boring at all. You're running trails and stuff.
But treadmills can. But the treadmill is so boring. And it's like, it's just pushing through that thing.
That's what I realized today. Actually, today I was writing.
Like, a real good mental test is running with no music.
That's what what I realized.
Because that really tested your mentality.
I was thinking when I was journaling that I was like my first journal ever, right? I did think that, and I was thinking about like this, and it was like, yeah, like, why are you doing cardio? It's like, obviously you're doing cardio to like to enhance your cardio. Obviously it's going to tighten up my leg muscles. It's going to help with this. It's going to help with that. But like also it's like one of the major reasons why we're working out, why we're at the gym is to enforce discipline. And I realized, I was like, man, like, just the same way as, like, if I can't lift something and I'm like, oh, my arm's weak, I need to work on that. Just the same way that I'm like, I'm out of breath in 20 seconds, I need to work on that. That's what I realized after I left the gym today, because I was thinking about the treadmill and I was like, me being so bored that I had to stop in 5 minutes, I was like, that's what you need to work on. Your fucking focus, your discipline.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that you're tapping out just because you're like, I'm bored, that is not a good quality. So tomorrow when I go, I'm like, now I got to extend how long I'm going to do that for. And now that you mention it, I'm not ready yet. But yeah, I'm going to start working my way up to like, let's do no music, because that's what we're there for. You know what I mean? Let's start doing 25 minute runs on the treadmill, staring at the wall, no music. Do you know what I mean?
But yeah.
Right now that sounds like a nightmare, but it's just like, if I can get past that, it's like even the rest of my day. Even on a dopamine level, you know how much I'm going to appreciate, like, at that end of that 25 minutes, throwing my headphones in and starting to listen to music and stuff? Like, you need to – that's where I'm like, okay, let's work on the discipline.
You know that – you know when Conor McGregor is – it's like, who the fuck is that guy?
Yeah.
He's talking about –
Colby Covington?
No. Is it Stephen Thompson? Is that his name? Anyways, I know.
That's so, like,
who the fuck is that guy? Well, that guy.
That's so funny. That was one of the best moments ever. And like what he said too, because it was like, who was that guy?
Well, here's the thing. For anyone who's a fan, you knew exactly who he was. Right. Like, he's like a fight, maybe two fights away from getting a title shot himself.
Really?
Like he's up there with all the stars, dude. Like, he's not a nobody.
Yeah.
Like, and he was on a fight streak at a night, but he was a nobody if you weren't a real fan. Like he right. he doesn't have he's only known to people who followed a sport.
Right.
Who the fuck is that guy? Right, because you had champs up there.
Yeah.
Right, like obviously you got McGregor and whoever he was fighting at there's the time, like Leon Aldo Edwards or whatever.
Up there,
no, think. Leon Edwards wasn't even in the UFC then.
No,
man, that was like 2013, 2014, man. It was forever ago. But like John Jones up there, Ronda Rousey was up there.
Okay, yeah.
Donald Cerrone might have been up there.
Cowboy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was. I thought it was like Colby or Donald Cerrone.
No, Colby Covington, Leon Edwards.
They weren't till later.
They were even in the UFC during that.
But
what I was gonna say was that guy. He was on Rogan.
Yeah,
and he was talking about how he goes for runs every day. Like he runs like these 2 hour runs.
Oh yeah,
with no music. Yeah, and he talks about how and like and Rogan was like no music why, and then he was talking about like just. You know, the mental battle because he's talking about like fighting, like so much of it is just your mentality.
Yeah.
And, you know, and like, and staying mentally tough inside the octagon.
Yeah.
So it's just like, yeah, like running with no music on is like, it's, you're alone with your thoughts, right? And it forces you just to be mental tough and have that mental stability.
Yeah.
And I was like,
it's
Jesus,
a meditation
yeah.
of its own.
Yeah. That's what he was saying.
Yeah.
Like, or something, he was saying something like that. But
yeah. I mean, you were talking about this with me the other day, and I think about this too, which is crazy because this is something that, wouldn't talk about this 20 years ago, but like that sometimes when you can't sleep to be like, all right, well, I'm just going to power through. And I've been there sometimes and I'm like, with whatever you do, don't go on your phone. And then it does take me 3 hours to sleep and I'm just lying in a dark room, just trying to sleep. But like, I have an amazing sleep if I can power through that. And also I usually like, if I'm refusing to pick up the phone, like I'll work through some stuff, but it sucks a lot. Sometimes I'm just thinking things and I think it deeply and then I start thinking the worst things and I start this and it starts hurting my soul and this and then it's just like, just keep going until eventually you're like, actually maybe you're overreacting and this and that. That might take like 3.5 hours, but if my mind's running, like let it run. You know what I'm talking about? But you remember you were telling me that happened to you the other day. You're like, I couldn't sleep. So you're like, I didn't go on the phone. And then you said you just let your mind run for like 3 hours and it got deep.
Yeah.
But you were like, but it was amazing.
Yeah.
Which is crazy to think that like that shows how much of a drug the phone is. That's
dude,
really
dude. Yeah, I do that all the time. I take. I go. This year, I really started driving. Especially since getting home from tour, the amount of time I actually man, you gotta understand. Like I've always and I've been known for always having music on the car and like always,
I mean,
always,
most
always.
People do
right.
Yeah.
I've always listened to listen to music in the car, but not like I used to, like, especially when I'm alone. Like the amount of times I drive with nothing on the radio now, or like I'm gonna or just the radio and it's sitting low and I'm not really listening to it.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot.
Yeah.
There's a lot.
You should get that lo-fi thing kicking on it too. Remember the lo-fi hip hop we had the other day?
Yeah. Is that the lo-fi hip hop? Is that what Luke and Leah used to have on Maggie? Because, yeah.
That's good, eh?
Isn't that wicked?
It's so good for, like, studying. And I can literally can read while that's on.
Can I scroll this up? Because, like, your head, you're, like, right at the top of the screen.
Is that right? Yeah, I was afraid of that. Yeah, move that up.
You got real afraid of that.
What? I
said real afraid of that.
Yeah.
It's one of my biggest fears.
Yeah, so you got to, no, sweetheart. You got to, like, does it not, what? Is it?
Do you think if you had the option, I was going to ask you the option, but now I don't, I think it's an obvious answer. Like, so back in the day when people were getting executed, everybody,
here's an obvious answer, but execution.
This has to be an obvious answer, but please tell me if I'm wrong, but everybody would prefer the guillotine over being hanged, right?
I guess.
Like your head just gets chopped off. It's done versus hanging. Hanging might last like a couple. Yeah. Hanging could last, I feel, a couple seconds. Really. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah.
When you hang, you see the people, you know?
Jesus, man, that's terrifying, isn't it?
Yeah. When you hang, it looks like when you're 5 and you're excited on Christmas. That's what they do at the end. They go like this, drop.
You know what? You're really good. See, this is where I struggle. But you're really good at just keeping it going and randomly go, what's your thoughts on this? What's your thoughts on this? What's your thoughts on that? Like,
yeah.
You know what I was talking about too earlier? Like, I like it just like to catch it, like if you were, chat, yeah. Whatever. But like, I can go, but like, yeah, sometimes when I'm on a podcast, like I can just freeze up.
Oh, that's happening in my head all the time.
Right?
Yeah.
But you're really good at just like
yeah.
keeping it going with like the most yeah. random questions.
I'm like, genuinely am curious too with all those random things. Yeah.
Yeah.
But it comes to me more if I'm doing a podcast or something like that. Mm. But I really am really curious with that stuff. A lot of stuff like that in my head. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm very curious to know people's answers. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? I think about this stuff a lot.
Back home where I was in Bjorn, they had the those guillotines. They had the on display. There's three of them.
I think it was.
Like mock, like the blades weren't in them.
Yeah.
But they were like about in museums.
Mm-hmm.
There's two museums where I live.
Do you think they were doing it down near there?
Yeah, that's what they're there.
1400s.
On display, like, but back in the day.
Yeah.
They used to, it had the two little holes where you put your hands in.
Yeah.
And then the big hole where you put your head in.
Yeah.
And, yeah. And
then they dropped the blade.
Yeah. They dropped the thing down, boom, cut your head off. Or actually, I think, but they might have dropped the blade. I think this one was a place to hold you. And then somebody would have a sword and come down with a sword and do it. Like the thing was just there to keep you in place.
Yeah.
But it could have been a blade. I don't know. I can't remember. I was only a kid. I didn't really ask enough questions. But yeah, it was there on display.
That's crazy.
It's still there right now.
That's cool.
It's kind of like, okay, you know, like Signal Hill had those like the cannons.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cannons. It's just, yeah, it's just like it's there on display.
Oh, for sure.
It's
like that. History. Yeah.
But it's, yeah. It was in the courtyard, like, and they used to do it out there, like, I don't know, in the 1800s, 1700s, yeah. Whatever it was. Like,
and people got to come watch.
That's so insane, man. Imagine watching that.
But would you not?
I'd go watch it if it was someone who wronged me. Or my family, especially someone wronged my family member.
I'd say you would, but like also like if I just knew somebody did something bad, somebody did something to kids, even if it wasn't personally a kid that I knew, I'd still want to go watch. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, because I guess anybody's up there doing that, doing something bad, you would think.
I mean, even but, if they but, just stole but, a piece but of it's gun like any, in the grocery but, store, but, I'd go watch. But here, let's be honest. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not going to lie to you, you know?
I don't. I wouldn't. Not a chance. Not a fucking chance.
You didn't watch
chance.
That stuff? Like, you
no, if it was over to, if it was over something small. Like,
I know, you'd feel bad.
But I'd be on feeling bad. Like, I would not be comfortable to live there anymore. Because I would be like you
yeah,
can't.
That was just the time.
You feel like you can't sleep.
It was. I'm not saying right now. I'm not saying me right now. Right now, I wouldn't want to watch it. But I'm saying me back then, 1400 me, I have a lot of different morals and theories. We don't want to get into 1400 me or 1400 you's head. We don't even know what AI is yet. Hell yeah, we want to see that. Dude, what else are we going to see?
Dude, AI is the guillotine of this society.
It's dude, forget about running with music. You don't have music. So if you want to go for a run, that is your music. You got to go see somebody's head wrongly get cut off. And then you run. You run out of fear.
Oh, my God.
Fear is your music.
Yeah.
Being like, I don't want that to ever happen again. Kind of. You would think about the guts coming out of the neck, and I bet you that is something. You would just run and be like. You would run until that feeling of fear shook off. That's how you did cardio back in the day.
So you think watching an assassination,
yeah,
back in the 1400s is like music today?
Kinda.
That's what Paul Thompson's saying.
Kinda, yeah.
Cool.
It would fuel you in many ways.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, just like music. Yeah. You know how you paint to music or whatever? If you saw someone's head get cut off,
you just paint that.
You wouldn't paint that, but you would be like, it would set a vibe. You'd be like, damn, that was crazy. You wouldn't be bored.
Just take a black roller to a fucking piece of paper.
you'd be painting and you'd be like,
paint it black.
Man, that was crazy. You know? Holy.
No, fuck that.
Yeah. No, I mean,
never.
Did you not never, ever have like friends, which was, I hope that this era has passed. I think we got it worse. And like when we were young, how do I know though? But like when you were like 14, 15, you didn't have your friends be like, yo, watch this video.
Dude, I was in high school, and I remember. Do you remember when
like we all had to go to high school?
Do you remember when America invaded Iraq?
Yes.
Because I do,
And I remember there was like
beheadings,
the beheadings, man. But I remember like there was a guy that like he was selling like radios or something, and he was American or he thought they were American, and like he wasn't nothing. He was just like American citizen, like the Taliban or the Al Qaeda or what was it at the time, is kidnap him. And yeah, he's on a chair.
And then we got that on the internet.
And they got a bag over his head, I think it was.
Yeah.
And there was like 8 or 9 guys with like ski masks on.
And then they hold up the head out.
And they did like a bread knife, man. Yeah. And like type of thing. And just kind of, and Buddy was like screaming. And all of a sudden his screaming just stops because he hit his vocal cord, right?
Yeah.
And he just keeps sawing it. And then they hold his head off like that. And I remember knowing
I don't want to watch this, but I remember hearing those screams.
But I remember it was a really, this was back when like MIRC, do you remember that program? It was like a real underground techie program. It was like, there was ICQ, so ICQ and MIRC are people used to chat to one another. And then all of a sudden like MSN and AOL Messenger came in, and then that's how everybody started talking to one another.
Yeah.
And then Facebook came along and Facebook killed off like MSN and that. But like, yeah. So, but MIRC was this like weird old school thing where it was like,
ICQ was around then.
Too. Yeah. It was the same time as ICQ. And like, you could get these chat lobbies, but it was like extra chat rooms, but like, and then in these chat rooms, people could get, they give you like these IP addresses and FTPs and stuff, so you could then, through other programs, you could key those numbers in, and you could see like files on other people's computers and download files off other people's computers. Similar to like Napster or anything like that, how you're just downloading off someone else's computer, but different. And you were getting right into like, you could see all the folders in someone's computer, like almost like you're going through their computer. It was like they would allow you to hack their computer so you could get the stuff off their computer and yours, right? And anyways, I remember like through that, like this video somehow got on the internet, like through the underground and leaked, and
the beheading,
yeah. And then I remember, I forget, and then, I remember being in a lobby and there was a link for it, and it just took you to like a website with just the video.
But you watched the whole thing.
And I said, it was like 8 minutes, and for some fucking reason, I sat down and I watched the whole like raw, unedited footage like 20 years ago.
But that'll fuck you up.
Yeah, and I remember just being full of cold shivers. And I remember when it was done, I was like, why did I watch that? Now, it didn't fuck me up like long term, but I do remember watching videos like all week, like I felt disgusting, and I felt a lot of shame for even watching it. Yeah. And I was just like,
and just like darkness in the world.
But there was a part of me that, in some way, I'm kind of glad I did watch it, because it really opened up a realm of reality that does exist in this world. And just like,
desensitizes, but you don't need to see the whole thing.
Not desensitizing, you don't need to. But
desensitizing is not a good thing.
when you see it the whole way through, and you're like, it really hits that really exists.
Oh, it sure does.
And it's like, and there's something to knowing that exists in my head and heart, that really actually, in a fucked up way, can help you in life, because it really makes you have more gratitude.
You're not naive to the world.
Well, you're not naive to the world, but it also gives you so much more gratitude for everyday, daily stuff.
And where we live,
exactly.
Yeah, that we don't live where they're beheading
exactly.
people.
Exactly. You know, and it really, like, yeah, and like when you're a teenager, like the stuff that pisses you off and that you get upset about and that you think is stupid and blah, 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 blah.
No, I know.
Like, watching something like that can really knock a lot of that nonsense out of you.
100%.
So, like, in that way, in the most twisted, messed up way,
you're right.
It is kind of good.
Yeah, like, I remember, like, when you say that, where it's like, yeah, like, it's not, like, long-term or whatever, but maybe. But
it can be if you're traumatized enough, but I wasn't.
But no, sure. But, like, I remember, like,
Like, I wouldn't ever try and, like, watch a full thing like that. But, like, I seen that video. But, like, I would watch for 10 seconds. I'm like, okay, I can't watch this. But I remember, like, hearing the screams. But there was a ton of stuff that I saw that, like, friends would always be like, yo, look at this. And, like, you would look over. And, like, even it would just be a picture. And it's like, I know everything I just saw. Even if I look away right away, it's like, I can't unsee that, you know?
You know one thing that everyone seen that I didn't see? I never actually watched it.
Two Girls, One Cup.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. How'd you know I was going to say that?
I just knew it. I knew that's what it was going to be. I don't think I saw it either, to be honest with you.
When I, because like,
actually, I saw but here's but the thing. I stopped watching it.
I had way less interest in watching it because I heard it was like diarrhea and cups and people were like drinking shit or something and yeah, getting put like, on their face. That? And I was like, why would anybody watch that?
Yeah.
Like, meanwhile, in the same. From that right. And in this.
my stuff's got to be way crazier. No one even dies. But, like, but I don't think that the video.
But I remember
me.
Thinking, why the fuck would anybody watch that?
I know.
And in the same year, I watched a beheading.
Oh, right.
And I'm like, but like, which, like, why would I watch either of it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I remember thinking, the Two Girls, One Cup thing. Yeah. Was way more messed up than watching a beheading. Like,
maybe.
I'm like, that's absolutely disgusting.
I remember though watching this backyard wrestling thing. Me and my buddy were watching it, and it was just kind of crazy because it was like just like an amateur camera, and they were doing their own backyard wrestling. But like it was like pretty realistic. So like, at the start, like it was like just like people jumping off ladders, landing on each other, and you could tell that they were actually getting hurt. But we're like, you know, I'm probably in like grade 10, so we're like, holy shit, and like started taking chairs and like knocking each other down to the point like they would start like bleeding, and we'd be like, this is nuts, you know what I mean? And then like, I'll just always remember, and this is where the reason why I'm bringing it up is when you're saying like it didn't affect you, but you're like, but for the next week, this is where I was like, I just remember at one point things just started escalating. Like at one point they like threw a guy down, and then like, there was like all this blood on his back, and then they were like, what is that? And like, oh, I guess they poured like nails on the ground or tacks. And I was like, oh, that's kind of, yeah, you know, you're starting to be like, huh. But I just remember at one point just like they grab this guy and he's like has him in a chokehold, and then the guy's like this, and you can just start to see like blood dripping down his face. But again, it's like not that good of quality, and we're like, what's happening? Just me and my buddy like this close up to the computer. We're like, what is that? And my buddy's like, oh, it's a cheese grater. And then we're like, what? And he's like, yeah. And then like, as we're still watching it, cluing in, he's just cheese grating the guy's forehead. All the blood's coming down. And then like, when we see that, and the guy like kind of collapses because he's lost so much blood. And then we're like, yeah, let's turn this off. And we're like, yeah, we'll turn it off. And then I just remember like, I just always will remember this where he was like, we were just kind of quiet for like a second. And he's like, do you want to play basketball or something? We're like, yeah. And I just remember being on his driveway in the front yard, just bouncing the basketball. And I'm like, that's like, I was probably 14 or something, but it was like, that was the day that I was like, we're not kids anymore.
Mm.
Like after we saw that, like we weren't like, and I remember just like us both bouncing the basketball and like, we weren't saying anything. Like we were both just like staring into the distance. And I remember for the next couple of days after that, like even like people, my parents would be like, you okay? I'd be like, yeah, yeah, yeah. You know? And again, I hear you too, where I was like, I was just grateful. I was probably a lot nicer to everybody around me, my sisters and stuff, but I was definitely just quiet. Because it just took me so long to, like, process. I was just probably quiet for a couple of days.
Yeah.
Like, damn. But I'll never forget bouncing the basketball in that driveway and just, like, all I could see was, like, the blood. And I was just, like, staring into the distance. And then I'd, like, look at him and he'd be like, yeah, 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 yeah. We'd both be like, yeah, you know? And, like, just be like, kind of like, what did we just see? But we also didn't want to talk about it. And we'd just be like, oh, fucked up. It's like the internet. That's – but what scares me about that – is as you were saying this, I randomly thought where I was like, yeah, that doesn't really happen anymore. And then I thought, I was like, you know what? Kind of it does. But then I was thinking like on WhatsApp, people share like really weird things. And like a few months ago, my buddy, again, just like trying to be like a dick, was like, sent me something and I opened it and I was like, it was really messed up. But I think about like, and I don't think that has to do with being older. Like I think about like what I saw. I was like somebody's like face was peeled off, and there was like a head that was beheaded. I just saw the picture, and I was like, "Is that what?" And I looked at it for a second. I was like, "Oh God!" I was like, "Why are you sending that to me?" But it didn't do anything to me. It didn't make me like. But I remember when I saw that before, my stomach would drop. I would physically feel like, "What the fuck?" But like now, we see so much shit. We're so desensitized with our phones and stuff. Like that's fucked up. We can see some pretty crazy shit, and like. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like fights, the amount of crazy real shit we see just on Instagram that like 15 years ago, if you saw it, you'd be like, that's fucked. Where now you're like, yo, look at this. I'm like, you'll watch it again. You're like, that's crazy. Somebody just gets bottled in a McDonald's, and you're like, damn.
Remember when Tim Hortons or Mrs. Shits in her hand throws it at the person?
Yeah. Like, that's like, and like, I feel like 20 years ago, I think like, we're in our 30s. I think if you showed that video to somebody in the 80s or the 90s, they'd be like, what the fuck? And that would stick with them for like a week.
Right.
They'd be like, what the fuck did I see?
Yeah.
Where now we're like, haha, cool.
Just like, we're just like, Jesus, man, people are fucked. Next.
Yeah, that's crazy. Next.
Yeah.
Like, it's fucked.
Yeah. You know?
We're very desensitized.
Yeah. But I mean, that's when any, like.
But then,
but that's human nature to get desensitized to anything. Like,
because is that different than the people watching the Coliseum and people,
there's people right now living in Africa and Asia and that, like, there's things they're so desensitized to. Yeah. Like, I think it's like, I think there's someone in Asia, like someone will just get creamed. Like T-boned, okay.
You gotta clarify. Yeah, like, I'm like, that's still happening. Like, it's called a bathhouse.
Like but, in a car accident.
Right.
Yeah. And there's people just drive on by and means nothing to them because they probably that's probably the 10th time in their life they've seen it happen. Like,
yeah.
You know what I mean? And it just like, meanwhile, if one of us were to see that, we'd probably have need therapy for years.
If we saw like, what, like I
like someone gets smoked by a car and fucking get killed or.
Yeah, you know, I saw the body and stuff, yeah.
You know what I mean? Or whatever, like, that would... Anything like that, but, like, there's people in big cities that they see that kind of shit all the time, and it kind of means nothing to them.
I mean, I've seen a lot of, like, big car crashes and stuff like that, like, in the city and that.
I've seen...
And, like, they're crushed.
I have rolled up on accidents that just happened. Like, I've been after being at a couple and being there before... There's ambulance or anything there. Like, it just happened. Mm-hmm. But I've never actually just been sat down watching and see that one and see that.
I never
and, like,
have
watch
either.
And you...
Like, not big. I've seen little ones and stuff, but I've never seen, like, a big, like...
Yeah, like...
Bam, you know?
I did see someone on a motorcycle get hit by someone on a car.
Ooh.
I did see that. Now, it wasn't horrendous, but it was... Holy fuck, it was enough.
Yeah, it's
like,
crazy.
Yeah.
Someone died next to me at the gym 4 years ago.
No.
Yeah.
Someone I live with died.
Yeah. And that happened right next to me. I was the only witness. Like, I had to stick around.
Oh.
You know what was fucked?
What was that like?
Like, I kind of just went through the motions, like, in the sense that I was just, like, cool. Like, I almost, like, was, like professional about it. Like, I was just, like, pretty calm. But here's my one regret. Was like, they asked multiple times the police and stuff, like, if you want therapy, we can provide that. I know, like, this has been traumatic. And I was like, no, I'm okay, you know?
And you wish you did it?
They just kept saying that. And then they called me too a week later and were like, we're just double checking how everything is. And like, if you want therapy, that can be provided. And I'm like, no, I'm fine. And like, honestly, like, that experience wasn't like, it was traumatic in a sense, but I knew how to deal with all that. But there is stuff. Especially in the past couple of years that I do want therapy for. So I'm like, I wish I took the free therapy where they're just like, when you saw the body die. And I was like, yeah, we'll get to that. But first, like, why doesn't my dad love me? You know what I mean? Like, I wish I took the therapy just for my own things. And then, like, usually when you see something traumatic, right? And I was like, what, when I was 16? Like, no, like the thing that happened in the gym. The thing, right. And we are going to get there. And this is still free, right? But I feel like my relationship with my family makes me feel like I don't have a family. You know what I mean? And they're like, right, but what does that have to do with what you saw? It does. We'll get there. Oh, we're out of time. Guess we'll see you next week. Like, I wish, I truly do wish. I was like, why didn't I take free therapy?
You know what's crazy is how, like, that's not a thing.
Free therapy?
Yeah, like, you know how you just call your family doctor? Mm-hmm. And like send an appointment, you're like, okay, we can get you next week on Tuesday. How's next week? Tuesday, 2 o'clock coming, because you got to come in and you got to tell me problems that you're having with whatever, right? Mm-hmm. Like, how is that like?
And I think
where you can just like, no, but like, not
it
like
might
that.
Not be high
like,
level.
Okay, you have a family doctor, like, right? Like, how doesn't everybody have like a family therapist? Right? You know what I mean? Where it's just, you just make the appointment like a family doctor.
Yeah.
And you go in and even just a half hour
It doesn't even need to be the same person for the family. I think that might be
weird. No, but I'm just mean the title
you're
of it.
Basically saying healthcare should cover
Yeah, therapy. I'm just the title of it. You got a family doctor.
Yeah.
That's the title of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's a family therapist.
But yeah, but like, you know, it's basically healthcare should cover therapy.
Yeah, like I don't understand that. Like I don't understand.
Yeah, I mean, it should.
How that's not a thing. Like
because like, that because some people like, might but, abuse
like,
it. Because
like we have health, like we have healthcare, right? It's free, but like and like that's healthcare. So why is like why isn't that basic healthcare? Because
it might
healthcare?
Be abused. Then there what? Might just because it might be abused.
Yeah, but everything's abused.
But there might just be some people that are like, cool, now I'm just like always gonna I mean, I guess that's fine. Yeah, you know what? I guess that's fine.
There's people who go to the doctor for every time they get a
oh, right, yeah.
There's people who go to the doctor for fucking heartburn, man.
Yeah.
Like I've done it.
I mean, maybe like, there's maybe they again just same thing with the doctor, so too. Like maybe there's just not enough therapists. Do you know what I'm saying? So it's like if you make that free to everybody, now there's the demand, there's not enough supply and demand. And the people that desperately do need therapy that are like, hey, well, like, I'll pay. Do you know what I'm saying? Like,
but it could, yeah, but just because there's not enough is still, to me, isn't a reason to have it because.
I mean, I agree. I think there should be, yeah.
It would just be, but, it would just be known, like, yeah, it exists, but like, it's always a shit wait and it's always just that. But like, I don't get how that isn't a thing in 2024. Like, I don't understand.
I'm how, sure and it I don't is somewhere
understand,
in the world.
And I don't understand. No, but in this country. Like, I don't understand.
But I bet you in Sweden or something.
Yeah, yeah, of course. It would be something like that. But I mean, here. Therapists. And, like, I don't understand how, like, there hasn't been a politician run on that.
I'm sure the NDP's got that plugged in somewhere.
I think we'd hear about it.
Maybe.
I think that'd be commonplace, man.
Yeah, I mean.
But they always talk about dental. But they don't ever talk about that.
I mean, I talk about a lot of
mental
people.
Health and like hospitals, like mental health hospitals.
Yeah.
Right? But they don't ever talk about like something just like that. I don't understand.
That you should be able to free therapy. Yeah. Yeah, you should.
Like, you got, like, you have a building.
I mean, and not a lot of people would do it. Like, there's a lot of people that would be like, I don't have time for that.
But
it's
I
like,
think.
But it's like, if you want to, that's what I'm saying. If you want to, you should
I
be able to.
I think so many people. Well, which one is it? What is, there's not enough doctors and be overflowing everybody who abuse it, or not enough people would do it? Like, I mean, like, it's.
I think some people might abuse it.
It's crazy,
but I'm saying that like that at the same time, there is a lot of people that would just be like, I'm never going to go to therapy. So whether it's free or not, they'd be like, I don't care. But more.
Yeah. But there's a lot of people that won't go like my dad won't go like it's different. It's a bit different out of the last few years. Cause he's hanging on by a thread.
Yeah.
But like,
he won't.
But like the amount of people in general, especially men from the baby boomers era, mm-hmm. like the amount of baby boomer men is bald, especially, I don't know if that's on the mainland, what's like in the mainland, but on the East Coast,
mm-hmm.
the amount of men and women too, but especially the men from the baby boomer era, that like refuse to go to the doctor or the hospital for anything. Boss can be half done. No, fuck that. Like,
yeah.
they got to be like passed out.
For
someone's
sure.
got to call an ambulance for them from to get to the fucking hospital. Like, these old men.
So they're not going to therapy.
No.
No
right?
chance.
So, but that's my point is that already exists in that world.
Yeah, that's what I'm
right?
saying.
So yes, it's right? So, yes, there's people who call the doctor.
I don't know which
people,
side it would
and
be.
And there's people who go to the hospital because they got a runny nose. You know what I mean? Like, now, today, there's people
so
that...
That's what I'm saying. I'm like, which one is it?
Right.
Is it going to be like...
But I think it would be... But I think
1,000 more patients? Or is it just going to be like, we can't do this because it's going to get blown up? And to be honest with you, I do worry about the younger generation in a sense.
Hmm.
That if you start introducing that there's free therapy to everybody...
Yeah.
That every kid 16 and up is like, okay, well then I'm doing that once a week.
Good.
Which maybe is good.
Would
yes,
be good.
I hear you.
I don't see how going to therapy can be bad for society.
Sure, but like
I think it would have positive effects.
Yeah,
on
you're
society.
Right. At the same time, yeah, you can just talk, like everybody can talk it out. And then some people might just be like, I'm just good on that. I don't need it. I don't know. I'm really torn. Is it gonna get abused and now everybody's gonna do it and then there's just not enough doctors? Or is it not going to be a difference? And now just like a couple people who couldn't afford it are going to get it.
I mean, you could show up to therapists and then it's a fucking real doctor and you're like, fuck sakes, I've been catfished.
You could. I've been fucking catfished. The catfish. God damn it. The catfish moves the same way somebody does 10 seconds after the hanging.
I think we're going to end on that. We're going to end on the hanging.
I was a millisecond away from making like a really like deep like comment about therapy and like needing therapy and stuff. And then you made the catfish thing. And I'm like, nah, I'll just make a hanging joke and then I'll tell you about it off camera. It literally was about to get real dark. And instead, and I was about to be like, you know, I know myself personally.
Nothing.
And then 3 seconds later, I just went down the door to the left.
Nothing better than a silly hanging joke.
I was about to get so dark and be like, I bet you if you roll that back, you could see my eyes. I was about to be like, I literally was seconds away from being like myself personally, I know. And then instead I was like, no, I'll go this way instead. The guy that gets hung looks like a fish.
Yeah. I think
I might hang myself tonight. Wouldn't that
I
be
think
silly?
A part of me would have said something like, throw this in their collar pack. that's too good. Hey, Mr. Paul Thompson.
All right.
Love you, buddy.
Love you, too. And that was a great...
Everybody can follow Paul Thompson. We're going to do more of these, obviously, but we'll plug it after everyone.
But great way to end it, too. Let's just
be real. That was great. Paul Thompson Comedy or Paul Thompson Comedy. What is it?
Thompson Comedy, yeah. Everywhere.
There you go, buzz.
Comedy on Instagram.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And, just find him there.
Sick.
All right, bro.
The catfish.